Welcome, everyone, to the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl here in Nashville, Tennessee. Under the lights at LP Field on the banks of the Cumberland River, the North Carolina Tar Heels, 6-6 out of the ACC, a picture of perseverance and resolve on their season.
13 Tar Heel players left behind in Chapel Hill, a pair of NCAA investigations, decimating the Tar Heels roster.
Waits, time flashes, incomplete. LSU wins it. North Carolina loses its ACC opener.
A 40-yard field goal to win it. Holy cow. The Tar Heels have come back.
And the Tennessee Volunteers out of the SEC. The Vols, a story of resurrection and redemptive qualities, able to save their season.
There's not one day that I didn't give everything I have to the Tennessee football program.
Penalty, Quadded had the game won.
Illegal participation on the defense.
On the Tigers. And Tennessee, perhaps one of the most devastating losses in school history.
4-0 in November and now bowl eligible. How did the Vols manage this?
And under the lights at LP Field, it's the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, the 13th edition from Nashville, Tennessee. It's North Carolina against Tennessee. I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey. Kara Capuano down on the field joining us in just a few moments. Bob, you look at these two teams on the field. They've overcome so much in so many different ways.
You know, Mark, as a coach, you always worry about motivation in a bowl game. You know, which team feels they have the most to prove? Which team really wants to be here? Because of all the things these two teams have been through this season, I expect a very motivated, well-played game, a very close game. These two teams are very similar on the field as well.
For Tennessee, it's their first trip to the Music City Bowl, and when you look around the crowd here at LP Field, a sellout. It's been that way for a number of weeks, some 70,000 strong, most of them clad in Tennessee orange. See a small smattering of Carolina blue down there on the lower level. But this is, in all effects, a home game for the Tennessee Volunteers. They're 15-0 in Nashville. North Carolina winning the toss, deferring to the second half. Tennessee will receive the opening kickoff. Derek Rogers on the kickoff return. And Rogers brought down at the 26-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 for the Volunteers. The starting quarterback, what a great story this guy is. Tyler Bray, a 6'6 freshman out of California, started the last four games of the regular season and really caught fire. He has been the catalyst for this resurrection in Tennessee. First down and 10. Torin Poole in the backfield behind him. He's the tailback out of the offset eye, and it's going to be Poole. And Poole brought down behind the line of scrimmage by Kevin Reddick. That's going to be a loss of one. And, Bob, let's take a look at our impact players.
Well, Tennessee has definitely turned into a passing team because the strength of their team is their receivers. Denarius Moore, I think the last four games has played as well as any receiver in the country. Luke Stocker struggled early in the year, has come on really strong at the end. It all comes down to pass protection for this young Tennessee offensive line. Quentin Copels has really had a great season, particularly when you think of all the suspensions Carolina's had on the defensive line.
Ray completes his first pass attempt to Luke Stocker. One of those impact players we were talking about a few moments ago. That's going to be a gain of 8 on the play as we take a look at the rest of the Volunteer offense. Talked about Poole and Fugit, the fullback, Stocker, the tight end. That offensive line, Bob, you said young offensive line. Youth is the operative word today for Tennessee.
Well, interesting. Three senior receivers, but three freshmen offensive linemen all line up next to each other. The center, the right guard, and the right tackle. True freshmen starting in the SEC for Tennessee on the offensive line.
On third and 2, the pass complete Out of the backfield, that's Gerald Jones, and Jones has a first down for the Volunteers. Picks up five out to the 40-yard line.
Tyler Bray, down on the field before the game. I thought he was tall and skinny just watching the tapes. Down on the field, that definitely confirmed it. 6'6", probably 205 pounds. Doesn't run real well, but has a definite knack for avoiding the rush. Could really be a special player at Tennessee.
Flags down on the field, and yeah, you talk about Tyler Bray had 1,234 yards in the last four games passing, 12 touchdowns against just four interceptions.
Well, you look at Derek Dooley, you know, he'd like to run the football more. You know, 1 point against Kentucky, they threw it 19 straight times, but they made a philosophical change during the season. I give him a lot of credit. He realized the strength of his football team were these senior receivers and this young freshman quarterback. There's no doubt they are a pass-first team, doing what they have to do to try to win.
This time they decide to run it between the tackles. That's Torin Poole, who's approaching 1,000 yards rushing on the season. And let's take a look at this North Carolina defense, a defense that has been undergoing changes pretty much from the opening week of the season and even beyond because of their unique circumstances. But Copel's the impact player, the main guy up front.
And another linebacker out with an injury, Bruce Carter, who has a chance to be a first-round draft pick. Zach Brown gets the start. Secondary, really pretty strong, but the safety's a little bit susceptible to deep balls down the middle of the field.
Bray down the middle of the field and incomplete at the 35-yard line.
Well, you're going to get a lot of cover two from North Carolina, and one of the ways to beat cover two is when you have a big talented tight end like Luke Stocker. Just try to get him down the middle of the football field.
Luke Stocker was a preseason All-SEC selection. Got off to a slow start. There he is, number 88, but has come on strong in the latter part of the season.
Let's watch these young offensive linemen, the right side of this offensive line and the left-handed center on the shotgun snap.
Bray given time. Incomplete. Threw it Luke Stocker's way once again, but threw it behind him.
Not many left-handed centers in this country. You see James Stone right there, the freshman from right here in Nashville. Yeah, that's what you call the head on the swivel in pass protection. And he found the right guy, number 90, eventually, Copples. Without a doubt, the best defensive lineman for North Carolina.
Chad Cunningham now standing at his own 24-yard line for Tennessee. Denora Searcy watches it bounce. Takes a North Carolina bounce. Out of bounds at about the 28-yard line. And that's where T.J. Yates will take the reins of this North Carolina offense. And this is a young man that has really endured a lot during the course of his four-year career in Chapel Hill. He's a 6'4 senior and put in some real stellar numbers in his final season on campus. He completed 68% of his passes through 18 touchdown passes. And the big difference this year, the dearth of interceptions, which is good for their offense.
Yeah, and at times, as hot as any quarterback in the country, really has had an outstanding senior year.
Sean Drone. And Drone, one of our impact players.
Well, North Carolina, they've lost four tailbacks this year. But Sean Drone, he's played a lot of football at Carolina. I think today he has a chance as a senior to step up and really leave an imprint on this program. And wide receiver Dwight Jones, he's had some huge games against Virginia and Florida State at 6'4", tough matchup for Tennessee. Nick Revaise at about 5'10", linebacker, really a productive player for Tennessee.
Yates completes it out to the 42-yard line. Ryan Taylor making the catch. He's the third leading receiver for North Carolina. And he picks up about 10 on the play for a first down. And let's take a look at the rest of this North Carolina offense. We mentioned it's an offense that's been decimated by various circumstances throughout the course of the season. Johnny White and Anthony Elzey, a couple of guys that were ahead of Drone on the two deep. But it's been the story of their season. Guys stepping up. To the boundary, Drone found the seam. Sean Drone gone. Touchdown, Carolina.
How many times we talk about the next guy in? We just mentioned a minute ago, Sean Drone. Watch the big guard pull around 64 right there. Jonathan Cooper gets the block, makes a great move in the open field on Jansen Jackson, the safety. But next guy in. And that's been the story of this Carolina football team. Sean Drone is a senior. Gets his chance to be the go-to guy. Has taken early opportunity and made the best of it.
With his sixth rushing touchdown of the season, that's been the mantra of North Carolina on the year. Next man in. And they've hung their hat on just that.
Proud to stand on our own.
Hey, let's stall him. I just found some Bud Light in the back.
Here we go.
We demand a helicopter.
Got it.
Oh. Well, we demand a hovercraft. A pipe organ. A Siberian endangered lynx. And my old high school track coach, Mr. Gill.
Hey, guys.
Oh.
They're good.
It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
This is the number to the hideout. You just give me a call whenever, okay?
Capital One presents Flashback Images 2003. The Battle of the Running Backs was won by Auburn's Ronnie Brown, rushing for 184 yards. The Tigers held the Nittany Lions to 3 field goals and won the game on Brown's 17-yard touchdown run with just over 2 minutes remaining. For more great images, tune into the Capital One Bowl on January 1st on ESPN.
On behalf of Franklin American Mortgage, our employees and industry partners nationwide, I'd like to welcome you to the 2010 Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. This year's game makes for an exciting matchup as the North Carolina Tar Heels take on the Tennessee Volunteers. The Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl is Nashville's holiday tradition, benefiting many local charities, and we're honored to bring this tradition to you. Please enjoy the game.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Sean Drone with a touchdown run, 58 yards just a few moments ago. North Carolina leading here in the 13th edition of the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. Mark Jones along with Bob Davey. Hey, from all of us at ESPN to all of you at home, all the best in the new year. Bob, it's already starting off to a pretty good new year for North Carolina here. What trials and tribulations they've been through over the last several months?
Well, first of all, both teams. You know, you always talk about a bowl game being a reward for a great season. I mean, Carolina at 7-5, Tennessee at 6-6. If you just look at the record, it'd be hard to say either one had a great season. But if you follow these teams, you see that it's a reward for these players. All that North Carolina has been through with the high expectations, and you see a senior like Sean Drone step up and run 58 yards for a touchdown, his longest of career. You look at Tennessee, these players have been through 3 head coaches, 3 strength coaches with different philosophical ideas, 3 different sets of terminology. This game is a reward for these seniors and all they have been through in these two programs. Both definitely deserve to be here.
Well, Rodgers on the kickoff return all the way out near the 30-yard line. And let's go downstairs to Kara Capuano.
Well, guys, when we talked to North Carolina head coach Butch Davis, his first comment was the age-old adage that adversity reveals character. Who has faced more adversity than these Tar Heels? To date, 35 different scholarship players have missed at least a game due to injury or NCAA investigations. Davis told us this team had every reason to underachieve, but the players would not let that happen, and their perseverance paid off, as you said, Bob, with the reward of this bowl game.
Well, Kara, Butch said this is one of the most challenging things I've ever done or had to do and endure. He said he couldn't have done it without all his players and great assistant coaches. Rodgers that time brought down by Dante Page Moss.
Just to finish on Kara's point, I think Butch Davis, in the eyes of this administration at Carolina that's worked with him every day through this, has genuine respect for the job he's done. And his motto all year, it's not who we don't have, let's worry about who we do have. And these players have really followed his leadership. He should be complimented on the job he's done.
On second and 14, Bray picked off at the 40. And then fumble after that. And Tennessee may have got the ball back. Kendrick Birdie had the pick. And Luke Stalker got it back off the fumble. That's the second interception of the year for Kendrick Birdie.
Well, first of all, Kendrick Birdie does a great job. Watch him up here in the corner. He's going to get high low. He's going to have one receiver in front of him, one behind him. He does a great job of playing the deeper of the two receivers. But then, as you see so many times, a defensive player not securing the football. That is a great play right there by the corner. But he just does not secure that football.
Looked like his own man actually knocked it loose. Dante Williams. Regardless, it's first and 10 for Tennessee. Does that play not kind of summarize North Carolina's season in a nutshell? They've gone to both ends of the spectrum of success.
Looks like Butch Davis called timeout, trying to buy some time to see if that can be further reviewed up here. Big Ten crew. Let's take Birdie. A look again.
Dante Williams ran into him and actually jarred it loose right there. While they review it, we're going to take a short timeout and come back with the verdict on the other side.
Your home, it's more than a dream come true. For most, it's the single biggest investment you make. Now, more than ever, you need a lender you can trust. Franklin American Mortgage, committed to strength and stability in lending, where every relationship is built on service and integrity. Franklin American Mortgage, lending you can depend on.
Michael McDonald. We'll see you in Music City.
It's game time, where you either go big or go home. The challenge, you've only got $5. Well, get ready. Hunger's about to get its bell rung. Taco Bell's Touchdown $5 Box. Get a loaded beefy crunch burrito. The legendary Crunchwrap Supreme. Classic crunchy taco. Crispy cinnamon twists. And an ice cold medium soda. The Touchdown $5 Box. It's $5 and it's good. Only at Taco Bell.
I should be shouting. I should be holding balloons. I should be jumping in the air for maximum year-end event effect. But then, like you, I'd want to punch me.
Now, for the first time, get 0% financing for 72 months on the 2010 Dodge Grand Caravan.
Welcome back, everyone, to Nashville, Tennessee. Here's the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It was a fumble. Tennessee ball. First and 10.
See Butch Davis right there. He used his one and only coach's challenge. You only get one in college football, whether you win or lose the decision. But because he lost the decision, he loses that timeout. So North Carolina now with two timeouts left in the first half.
What a real big swing in circumstance there for North Carolina after the nice pick. First and 10 now for Tennessee. Torrin Poole dotting the I. Poole takes the handoff right up the middle. Down by Deontay Williams.
Yeah, Torrin Poole is a capable running back. I mean, he's averaging 82 yards a game. He's had 994 yards on the ground. Small, fast. But really, just a philosophical change by Derek Dooley to just throw the football. It's not because Torrin Poole isn't productive. It's just that the receivers and the quarterback, he feels, gives him the best chance to win.
Second down. Bray juggled and incomplete at the 37-yard line. In and out of the hands of the normally reliable freshman, Justin Hunter.
Well, Justin Hunter, you talk about three freshman offensive linemen starting for Tennessee that are big, good-looking players. Justin Hunter, Jim Chaney, their offensive coordinator, who has been all around at Purdue in the NFL, said maybe the most talented I've ever been around at about 6'5". So a tremendous future. Four freshmen on that field right now for Tennessee. Actually, five, because the quarterback's a freshman.
And here he is trying to pull the trigger, but under duress. And Bray Wisely throws it away under some big-time heat up front. Tydreek Powell. And his fourth down coming up for the Volunteers. Jared McAdoo also there.
Yeah, North Carolina coming with a twist stunt up front between the tackle and end. When you see Tyler Bray, even though he doesn't run real well, he does have good instincts to avoid pressure.
It's interesting during some of the pregame comments during the course of the week that Coach Butch Davis compared him favorably to Ken Dorsey, a guy that he coached at the University of Miami in Cleveland with the Browns. On the punt return, that's Denoris Searcy with a couple of yards on the return on the 38-yard punt, but we have a flag down on the play. To go against the Volunteers.
Offside, number one, defense. That penalty's declined. It'll be first and 10, North Carolina. Timeout.
So T.J. Yates with the ball and in control of the Carolina offense when we come back.
ESPN College Football, the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, is brought to you by Franklin American Mortgage Company. Let our service guide you home. Nashville Convention and Visitors Bureau. And the Touchdown Big Box, only at Taco Bell.
The 2011 Rose Bowl game, New Year's Day on ESPN.
Make your anniversary as memorable as the day you said I do with a romantic weekend celebration at a Gaylord Hotel. We'll help you celebrate this important milestone by giving you your second hotel night free. Relax. Renew. Indulge in style. Gaylord Hotels helps you create memories. To reserve your unforgettable anniversary weekend, visit GaylordHotels.com/anniversary.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide. Roll Tide, y'all. Roll Tide, my friend.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide?
Yep.
Y'all don't even know he was a virgin until he's 28, and now, Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
He will always be remembered. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide.
The contrast of infinite black. The clarity of fast-switching phosphors. The smoothness of 600 hertz. All come together to create what CNET calls the best picture quality of any 2010 TV. The Viera Full HD 3D TV from Panasonic. Get a bonus Avatar Blu-ray 3D disc from Best Buy when you buy a Viera 3D TV.
New Year's Day, Capital One Bowl Week continues with three games on ESPN's family networks. First, at 1 on ABC, Urban Meyer looks to end his career at Florida with a win over Joe Paterno's Penn State Nittany Lions in the Outback Bowl. Also at 1 on ESPN, Alabama meets Michigan State in the Capital One Bowl. And at 1:30 on ESPN2, catch the Progressive Gator Bowl as Mississippi State takes on Michigan. Capital One Bowl Week on ABC, ESPN, and ESPN2 New Year's Day. First and 10 for the Tar Heels from their own 32. Drone stopped up after a gain of about one on the play. Evan Leathers makes the stop. It's the first meeting between these two teams since 1961, and the 32nd meeting overall. North Carolina going quick here. The pass complete. Dwight Jones, the big playmaker for the Tar Heels, and he's up close to a first down. His forward progress going to be marked just about a yard short, and a gain of 9 on the play.
You see that up tempo. You know, North Carolina felt like they could confuse Tennessee a little bit. You know, Tennessee does a lot of different things on defense. They really are a scheme defense. And sometimes up tempo, you can catch them not getting lined up or not executing their assignment.
To Drone, and Drone takes it for the first down across the 45. And let's check in with Dario Noka back in the studio.
Guys, just so everybody's aware, over on ESPN2, you get a little Big Five hoops. Rivals Villanova, Temple. Last season, unranked Temple beat third-ranked Villanova. In fact, it was the Wildcats' only loss in their first 21 games. Temple with the early 6-4 lead over on ESPN2.
I love the Big Five, Dario. Looking out of the shotgun, there's a flag down.
Full start, number 66, offense.
It's against the right tackle, Mike Ingersoll.
Mike Ingersoll, the senior offensive tackle. The other offensive tackle, James Hurst, a freshman. Also, Alan Pelk, the right offensive guard, out for this game with injury. Travis Bond getting the start at right offensive guard for Carolina.
Number 41, Yates. Completes it to Ryan Taylor. And Taylor makes it out to the 45-yard line. Let's talk about T.J. Yates, a guy that's really endured a lot during his career. Last year had 12 touchdown passes, 14 interceptions. This year, Bob, he's been able to flip those numbers. How do you think it's happened?
Well, it's amazing because he's lost his number one wide receiver, his number one tight end. He's lost about three running backs. He's not been a guy that the stereotypical just manage the game. He's had to carry this team. So he's had a remarkable senior year.
Completes a quick hitter here. That's Joshua Adams, who picks up four on the play.
This is something that Carolina is going to do today. You know, I mentioned Tennessee plays so many different defenses. They used to be a check with me, check a lot at the line of scrimmage. This is just the quarterback and the wide receiver, the only two that even know that's coming. Just a little sight adjustment. Instead of checking at the line against all these multiple looks, they're just going to have a little hot read between the quarterback and the wide receiver, Mark, even sometimes on running plays.
Told you it was pretty much a home game for Tennessee. Listen up. Incomplete, intended for Taylor again. And it's fourth down. North Carolina's going to punt.
Yeah, threw it behind him a little bit. I think Ryan Taylor, who's really come on here late in the season as a tight end, DJ Yates just threw that football behind him because there was some run after catch yards. And here's the real story. The Tennessee punt return game. They've played about six different returners this year. They just want a guy that will catch the football.
Yeah, right now, it's Anthony Anderson's turn.
Yeah, he did it against Kentucky. The good news, he didn't fumble one. So he's back there.
Feagles with the punt. A spiral that goes over Anderson's head and into the end zone. 51 yards in all, but only a 31-yard net. There's a flag on the play. That goes against North Carolina.
I think Derek Dooley, with his problems in the punt return game,
did not chance it.
Yeah, he may just decline this thing and say, okay, let's take it at the 20.
Derek Dooley there, just the fifth Tennessee coach to lead his team to a bowl game in their first year.
Only had six players. The line scrimmage, five in the backfield. Tennessee has elected to force that penalty from the touchback, the first and 10, 25-yard line.
There you go. It's tagged on to the end of the touchback.
Hey, what about Tennessee? When you look at the monthly breakdown, Bob, they lost two. They won only two out of their first eight games and then had a big rally down the stretch. Out of their first six, pardon.
Yeah, I mean, they're 2-6 at the end of October, and that's why I have so much respect for these seniors, particularly with this youth movement going on at Tennessee, which I'd be doing if I was a head coach. But these seniors win in their last four football games. Here's one of them right here, Luke Stocker.
Stocker makes the catch, gain of about seven on the play. And Coach Dooley talked about it to us. He said, this thing wouldn't have worked out. It would not have turned around if it weren't for the seniors really accepting the freshman on the team and making it happen.
Well, let's talk about the wide receivers. Guys like Denarius Moore, Gerald Jones, Luke Stocker. They really struggled early in the year. They could have packed it in. I mean, if you don't have great leadership and a great job by the coaching staff, keeping these guys motivated every day, at 2-6, you pack it in. So I have so much respect for these seniors and the job Derek Dooley has done. He has learned an awful lot in his first year as a head football coach at Tennessee.
Well, the injured player down to the field is Deontay Williams, number 27 for North Carolina. And it looks like they're bringing out some extra medical care to take care of him.
I hate to see this, as everybody does. Deontay Williams, 46 starts.
Looked like that right leg, or pardon me, the left leg might have given out on him.
He bent that right leg under, it looks like. But 46 starts for Deontay Williams. Missed the first four games this year.
Talked about the fact that North Carolina has had 35 different players miss time this year because of the NCAA investigation or injuries. And injuries, the issue right now down in the field with the 6'2 senior Deontay Williams. We'll get the rest of the story on the other side.
There are all kinds of people at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, each with big ideas for the world. Some want to cure, others to find. Some to invent, protect, inspire. or solve. At Carolina, we love a good challenge, and this planet is a big one. So keep an eye on our ideas. We see great potential, world. UNC Chapel Hill. Minds on a mission.
What could you do in a place that encourages and inspires you?
A place that doesn't teach limits, but creates possibilities.
And connects you with the best minds.
What could you change?
What could you create?
What could you become?
The University of Tennessee is dedicated to the what could happen in all our students' lives. The University of Tennessee, a place to imagine a better future and then do something about it.
You're watching ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
Back here at LP Field in Nashville for the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. 7-0 with 5:32 to go in the first quarter. We just had an injury down in the field a few moments ago, and it seems to be quite severe. Deontay Williams, the 6'2 senior defensive back for North Carolina, was in on a tackle on Luke Stocker on the last play, and his right foot seems to be what is at issue right now. We have Kara Capuano down to the field as our sideline reporter tonight, and she'll be investigating further as to the condition and the health of Williams. But this has been in large part the story for North Carolina this year. It's been a situation where they've had to endure injuries and a lot more.
Anytime setbacks happen,
they put him in a soft cast there, you can see, and they're taking the cart out, are going to take him off the field. And you hate, as a senior especially, Bob, for your career to end that way.
Well, the point I was going to make, Mark, about just this entire Carolina football team, you see the emotion right there on those players with a severe injury like that. But why you give Butch Davis and his team so much credit, they had a built-in excuse with all. You're talking about 41% of their team has missed time because of suspensions or injuries. That's a built-in excuse to fail. There's a safety net there. But instead of taking that approach feeling sorry for themselves, they stepped up and persevered.
Let's check in with Dari Noka back in the studio.
Yeah, guys, how about the game that preceded this? The New Era Pinstripe Bowl, a little controversy, certainly has the social network sites abuzz. Here you go, K-State down 8, touchdown. They need a 2-point conversion, but the salute, letter of the law, brings attention to himself, does Adrian Hilburn. The salute cost them 15 yards. They got to go for 2 from the 18. It's no good. Syracuse wins, but K-State fans not happy with this one, guys.
I've seen that one before. That happened to us in 1999, playing at the University of Michigan.
Do you like the call by official or not?
I don't. I know by the letter of the law, you have to call it. I guess I thought in a bowl game on a play like that, just warn the kid, keep the flag in your pocket.
Tyler Bray downfield, a lot of contact and incomplete, and a flag thrown at the 30-yard line. Justin Hunter was working against Jabari Price. And there was a lot of bumping and grinding going on down the sidelines.
Well, that is two freshmen working against each other. And Jabari Price just used his body and forced him out of bounds, and really no need to. You know, he panicked just a little bit right there. Good call. I mean, Justin Hunter really can be a special player. That was a good call. You can use your body a little bit if that ball's in the air, and as a defensive back, you're looking back to the ball. At that time, the ball wasn't even in the air yet. He just drove him out of bounds.
Tennessee has the ball near midfield now at the 48. Meanwhile, Gene Robinson has come in for the injured Deontay Williams. Robinson number one in the secondary. Torin Poole lining up the deep back out of the eye. And it's Poole on the toss. Couldn't quite get to the edge and has run out of bounds right at the 49-yard line on North Carolina's side of midfield. Robinson, who just came into the ballgame for Williams, made the stop on the play.
You always worry, and it's a reality of such a graphic kind of injury. Deontay Williams right in front of that Carolina bench, all those Carolina players out there. That's where you show your mental toughness, where you just have to bounce back and you just play again.
Yeah, they were openly distraught by what they saw.
No question.
Second and seven as Poole just went over 1,000 yards rushing on the career. On the season, actually, and here he is again, adding to that number. Sturdivant makes the stop, and Kara Capuano has an update on Williams.
Well, guys, as the video evidence revealed, it is an injury to his lower right leg. They're taking Williams back for x-rays, and his return at this point is highly doubtful.
Well, you would think that he would come back after seeing what we saw.
I can go beyond that. Highly doubtful.
Yeah. Nose of the ball at the 42-yard line. Third down and short for Tennessee. They're actually going to bring the chains in and measure. Well, they're that close. This game against North Carolina, step up in competition for Tennessee. They have yet to defeat an FBS team with a winning record this year. They did finish out on a nice four-game winning streak, but some people might question the strength of their respective opponents during that streak.
But I'll say this. Life in the SEC in the last month of the season, I don't question anything. To win four games in November, three of them in the SEC, I don't care who you bring.
On third and one, Gray keeps it himself and uses all of that 6'6" frame to uncoil and get the first down at the 40-yard line. Picks up three. Well, there's great lineage on the sideline there for Tennessee coach Derek Dooley in his first year.
Yeah, I had a chance to visit with him, as we did, Mark, during the week and then down there on the field before the game. I mean, you really have to put on that resume up there at the top. Son of Vince Dooley.
Yes.
I mean,
that'll open a couple doors, too.
And what a great experience. So he's lived it.
Gray looking to pass with time. And that dangerously close to being picked off. Denarius Moore was the closest Tennessee player in the area.
To talk about a resume, Vince Dooley's son, living it every day. Then he was on the coaching staff with Nick Saban for 7 years. And I love the way he talked about his relationship and his experience with Nick Saban. He said it was really like a boot camp, like a 7-year boot camp. And he meant it in a very positive way of how every day he realized it may be not easy, but what a great chance to learn about coaching and being a head coach. So, I mean, Nick Saban has developed some head coaches now,
yeah,
and will continue to.
And to think that he actually did a couple of years of law school and finally said, enough of this. There's enough litigators out there. I'm going to football. You know, his dad, Vince Dooley, the iconic Georgia football coach for 25 years. And in those 25 years, Bob, Derek Dooley not only saw his father as a football coach, but for a good portion of that time, the athletic director of Georgia, too. So you really get the big overall picture.
Well, here's the great thing for Derek Dooley right now, winning these last four games. He now has tangible evidence that his plan works. So every recruit's home he goes in, every Tennessee Vol booster meeting, he doesn't have to talk about blind faith. Just wait till next year. I'll prove we're going to be better. He won his last four games. So that's the proof right there. And with that comes momentum. So winning those four games, you can't put a dollar value on that now.
And to be able to do it with 16 freshmen that played this year at different times. That's a young core.
And the biggest thing, he's brought stability to this program. You know, you think about 1 year ago, Tennessee, what, 7-5, Lane Kiffin's the head coach. And there's one of those Lane missed playing in bowl games. That sting won't go away for these Tennessee fans.
3rd and 10. Gray completes it this time. Forward progress going to be marked at about the 31-yard line. That's short of the first down. Gerald Jones made the catch for the gain of 9, and Kara has more. Kara?
Well, guys, to finish up your story on Derek Dooley, we were at Sanford Stadium this season when Tennessee played at Georgia, and I caught him right when he walked into the hallowed stadium, and I said, what are you thinking about right now? And he remembered the corner of the stadium when he was a little kid where he used to play paper football with his friends. That was the first thought that crossed his mind.
He's got a lot of great memories. 4th and short coming up for the Vols.
Tennessee 6-for-16 on 4th downs this year.
I'm going to love it. Poole looks like he got the first down. Just making it across the 30-yard line.
It's interesting. With all those freshmen on the right side, they kind of did what you expected them to do. They ran to the left side behind Dallas Thomas and Gerard Shaw, the left guard and left tackle.
Gives him a first down with 2.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. The only score of the game, a 58-yard touchdown sprint by Sean Drone. This is the 9th play of the Volunteer drive. Gray wide open. Touchdown, Jones.
Tennessee gave him a little different formation that time. Derek Rogers in motion. Gerald Jones at a wing position running a wheel route. North Carolina.
And for Gerald Jones, his 4th touchdown catch of the season, the 13th of his career. Bob, what happened here?
Well, first of all, a little bit of confusion, but if we freeze that, you're going to watch right here. This is Gerald Jones. The outside receiver is going to come here, and they're going to run a wheel route, and they're going to turn him loose. Watch the corner go inside and fight on the inside route. And a wide open Gerald Jones. See the corner fight right there? And there is nobody left. Well-designed play. And again, Jabari Price, number 4, the freshman corner. Anytime you play a freshman, it's an evolving process. You just don't get to see those many different looks. He may have saw that one for the first time right there.
Tennessee tied the game up. Jones and Moore, the other receiver's counterpart, a couple of seniors who are roommates, have developed some really good chemistry with the freshman quarterback, Tyler Bray. 9 plays, 75-yard drive, using up 3.5 minutes on the clock. Harrelson on the kickoff return. And Harrelson makes it out to about the 28. Well, Bob, sometimes you doubt the motivations, as we talked about earlier. But so far, both these teams seem to be bringing it.
Yeah, and I never doubted the motivation for this game, just because of the journeys of these two teams. You know, there's a lot of different ways to get to 6-6. But when you won your last 4 games to get to 6-6, you're going to be motivated to go play a bowl game. And the same thing for North Carolina. So motivation, not a problem in this one.
Yates completes it out to the 37-yard line. Christian Wilson with the catch. Wilson picks up 8 on the play. It'll be 2nd down, about 2 to go. 1:47 to go
in the first quarter. I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey and Kara Capuano down on the sidelines here at the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. And the 32nd meeting all time between North Carolina and Tennessee, a couple of teams that haven't met since 1961. Drone brought down at about the 37-yard line. Nick Reveille with the stop, a gain of one in this battle between a couple of border states, Tennessee and North Carolina. These two teams were actually supposed to meet in a series, Bob, but contractually it, I guess, was null and void.
Yeah, it really seems like just a natural that these teams would play. There's no question this is a home game for Tennessee right now. It is all orange in this stadium.
First down, Drone, the touchdown maker for Carolina, picked up 10. And we're under a minute to go here now in the first quarter.
Well, he got a good block by the tight end. The left tight end right there pins number 17, Brent Brewer, the safety inside. And then Sean Drone bounces it outside for a big first down.
Here's Drone again. Stopped up at midfield, got about two, and Bob, that underscores the point. You mentioned the tight end blocking on the last play. Their first string tight end, Zach Pianalto, was their leading receiver at one point this season, and he's another key part that North Carolina's missing here in this game. There he is injured.
Exactly. And then Ryan Taylor, 11 catches in the last two games. Another example, Mark, of just the next guy stepping up and taking advantage of the situation. Yeah, I mean, Zach Pianalto was a heck of a receiving tight end.
It tells you that Butch Davis, I guess, is doing some pretty good recruiting if he's got guys filling in and becoming productive.
Yeah, you can see why the expectations were so high coming into this football season for Carolina.
That's the end of a busy first quarter of play between North Carolina and Tennessee in the country music capital of the world. We'll be back for the second period right after this. And welcome back to Nashville in the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. And speaking of champions, sometimes defining one, you have to look beyond the numbers. And these two teams and their records kind of evidence of that. North Carolina at 7-5, Tennessee at 6-6. A couple of motivated teams on the field tonight, 2nd and 8. Gates wisely throws it away. Good pressure up front by Nick Reveille. Here's a recap of the first quarter of play. Sean Drone with a 58-yard scamper for the touchdown has 80 yards rushing so far.
Yeah, really a couple big plays. Sean Drone with a 58-yard run. And then Gerald Jones, the wide receiver, with a big touchdown reception for Tennessee.
Kind of a free pass.
Exactly. Carolina turned them loose.
3rd and 8. Gates. Incomplete. Threw it behind Drone out of the backfield. Darryl Vereen there in coverage from the linebacker spot. And it's 4th down for Carolina. That's maybe the difference between Gates this year and last year. Last year might have tried to force that in, Bob, and get intercepted. This year threw it away.
Yeah, really good coverage by Darryl Vereen, the linebacker.
Anthony Anderson standing at his own 10-yard line.
You know, for Carolina, the loss of all those players with suspension, what it really affects these special teams, because this is where the depth really shows, or lack of depth shows.
Eagles punt into the wind, and Anderson calls for the fair catch of the 14. Let's go back to Dari Noka for the Sports Center right now.
Guys, thank you. It's not looking good for Brett Favre to play Sunday in what looks like his career finale. He failed his most recent neurological test as he tries to come back from a concussion. Head coach Leslie Frazier says Favre's ability to play will be determined by Saturday. Mississippi State head football coach Dan Mullen agrees to a new 4-year contract, paying him over $10 million over the life of the deal, $2.65 million per year. Mullen, 13 wins in 2 seasons in Starkville. SportsCenter now, guys, on ESPN News.
All right, Dory, back here first and 10 from the 15-yard line for the Volunteers. Tyler Bray in at quarterback. Poole, the deep back, out of the offset eye. A play fake, and Bray fires incomplete. You know, Bob, when you look at Tyler Bray, what a journey it's been for him. His coming out party was during the game against South Carolina, where he came in and went 9 for 15 for 159 yards, a couple of touchdowns. And he really kind of wrestled the job away from Matt Sims to where he is right now.
Well, you see Quentin Copeland almost wrestled that football away from him. But tough season for Matt Sims. And I spoke to him before the game. You know, early in the year, Tennessee, philosophically, wasn't throwing the football like this. You know, Tyler Bray's had the advantage of these receivers really coming on late in the season and the philosophical change. So, you know, difficult year for Matt Sims.
As part of that philosophical change, the pass complete to Michael Rivera. And Sims forced to watch things now from the sidelines. And initially, he voiced his displeasure with the decision to become the number two guy.
Well, I can understand that. You know, I spoke to him before the game. And how many stories around college football? It's easy to say, hang in there, stay. But all of a sudden, in one snap, he could be back in there and have an opportunity to shine and get everything out of this career that he wanted. But right now, it's Tyler Bray. And you can see why Tennessee people are excited about him. The kid definitely can throw the football.
On the end around, that's Gerald Jones. He's going to be dropped for a loss of a few yards on the play. Copels makes the sack. Sims watching and helping get those plays in from the sidelines. Tyler Bray, the laid-back Californian. And there was a point where he really had to step up and literally voice his command to this team. It was during the Ole Miss blowout when he really got in guys' faces and said, guys, quiet, let's get to the next play. It kind of turned a lot of heads at the time. A loss of three on the last play. Ray complete at the 32. And Jones falls forward to the 34, a gain of six.
You know, Tyler Bray, really not that highly recruited out of California. Committed to San Diego State. A lot of people concerned about just his physique. You know, so tall, so thin. But he has instincts. Plays with instincts right now. And, you know, that's maybe the biggest attribute he has. I mean, you can just see how tall he is. He's not well-oiled, but he's very instinctive.
His dad's 6'8".
Really?
Yes. Bray caught at the 48. What a grab by Denarius Moore. And there you see some of Bray's elusiveness, buying a little time and scrambling for the gain of 19.
And that's what I'm talking about, instincts, Mark. I mean, you don't think he'd be a guy that can move around the pocket, but he has good instincts when to slide. And how about the catch by Denarius Moore? I'll tell you, the last 4 weeks of the season, he made four catches against Kentucky. I mean, he has made Tyler Bray look as good as Tyler Bray has looked now. Make no mistake about it. But they're working on Jabari Price, the freshman.
Play fake. Bray going up top for the freshman. And incomplete, intended for Justin Hunter. And for more on Bray, here's Kara.
Well, guys, when Tennessee was deciding when it was the right time to bring in Tyler Bray, Coach Dooley told us they were very methodical in their approach to his development. What the Volunteers coaching staff didn't want to do was play Tyler Bray before he was ready. But three things impressed Dooley. First of all, the stature, the size that allows him to see the whole field. Secondly, his accuracy. And third, those instincts that Bob's been talking about.
Has his team on a four-game win streak coming into tonight. Second and 10. Matches. And incomplete, in and out of the hands of Denarius Moore. Had to get twisted around and try and make a catch out of it. Bernie in on the coverage for North Carolina.
Yeah, Denarius Moore has made those kind of catches. I mean, he has 12 catches over 30 yards this season. Tatum, Texas, state champ in the 110 hurdles.
I know you recruited Tatum, Texas at some point. I know you're the Lord of the living room, man. I heard about you. Third and 10. Ray out of the shotgun. Quick slant picked off. Juggled and intercepted. Zach Brown. And he's got a convoy of blockers. Zach Brown deep into Tennessee territory.
He tried to force the ball into Luke Stocker on the under route. Just a great effort play right there, getting that football out. And you talk about a guy that can run now. Zach Brown, 10-6, 100 meters in high school. He's their number one tackler as a linebacker, getting the start today because of the injury to Bruce Carter. That was a heck of a play.
Sure was.
By Gene Robinson knocking that football out now.
Carolina working on a short field. We got a flag on the far side of the field. But what a play that time by Zach Brown.
Ball start, three, three, offense. Five yards, three, three, still, first down.
That's against Dwight Jones.
You know, Mark, we talk about the next guy in. Gene Robinson, number one, he's the next guy in. He came in for Deontay Williams, who had that injury. Another example of the Carolina football season right there.
Sure is. First and goal. Hand off to Drone. And Drone gets a couple. Well, Friday, Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN. Three games at noon. South Florida takes on Clemson in the Meineke Car Care Bowl. At 3:30, Georgia makes their 14th consecutive bowl appearance against Central Florida, the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. And at 7:30, South Carolina Gamecocks take on Florida State in the Chick-fil-A Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN Friday. Second and goal coming up for the Tar Heels. Now they go empty formation. Gates. Loose. That's going to be ruled incomplete. But what a stick by Brent Brewer, the former baseball farmhand and second round pick. That was a home run hit, Bob.
Yeah, that's a great way to say it. That's a baseball player. That's a great lick dislodging that football right there. You know, he signed with Florida State out of high school for football in 06. Played in the Brewers organization for 4 years. Big hit right there.
And couldn't hit the curveball. Yeah. Right, huh?
You always come to that point when you say, you know what? I'm not going to make it to the majors when reality hits.
It's always that slider or breaking ball that gets him. And it looked like he even lost his hat, knocked a couple screws loose on his hat. The hit was so jarring.
Boy. He put the helmet right on the football. And Ed Barham, the big tight end at 270 pounds, couldn't hold on.
Tennessee calls a timeout.
You see the young talent there. You really do. I mean, it's kind of a unique blend of older guys, Phil Former guys that were recruited, and then you have the younger guys.
How do you bring the two groups together? Yeah. You got the seniors here who are on their way out. They want to win now. And well, the freshmen are just happy to be in the show sometimes.
Great point. That's why I'm saying the job Derek Dooley did, keeping this thing together and being able to motivate those different factions. Because you know what? Those seniors, when they came to Tennessee, they didn't sign up for all this now. There's been a lot of change.
Wide open in the flat. Drone. And a good open field tackle by the Volunteers.
Number 42, Thompson got there first. LaMarcus Thompson, and a gain of just one as a result. It's fourth down.
Well, Tennessee's always been known for those undersized linebackers who can really run. LaMarcus Thomas that time, number 42. And one of those seniors that we were just talking about. Watch him close. Really looks like a defensive back.
It's really going to come from about 28 yards out. Casey Bart. 16 of 19 on the season. And he knocks through that chip shot to give North Carolina the lead with 10:24 to go in the first half. And it was the big hit. And they capitalize off the interception.
Wrench.
Wrench.
Ratchet.
Ratchet.
Basic?
Preferred.
Okay.
At Meineke, I have options. So I choose what's best for me, my car, and my budget. My money, my choice. My Meineke.
Look, I don't want to work forever.
Then we need to figure this out now. Our nest egg took a real hit.
What's that website your friend mentioned?
RetirementRedZone.com?
That's it, from Prudential.
Yeah, she talked to her financial advisor about what she learned there. Said it really helped her get back on track.
Oh, I like that.
Help get your plan back on track. Watch our educational video at RetirementRedZone.com, the site for the critical years before and after retirement.
Maybe I can retire after all.
Now you're talking.
Click RetirementRedZone.com, then talk to your financial professional.
I should be shouting. I should be holding balloons. I should be jumping in the air for maximum year-end event effect. But then, like you, I'd want to punch me.
Now for the first time, get 0% financing for 72 months on the 2010 Dodge Grand Caravan.
It takes a lot to know what is love.
All right, don't hold back now. Give me all you got. Maybe baseball is your game.
Hey, pal. Bring it in right here.
You were always there for me.
How about golf? Okay, choke down a little bit.
Guiding me.
Ready?
Always to succeed. You wanna thank you for that time.
Appreciation. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now. Go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything, but lay off of my blue suede shoes. You can burn.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Bob Davey, Mark Jones.
Songs about Tennessee with Elvis down on the West End there. Rocky Top, Walking in Memphis, Arrested Development, one of my favorites. Graceland, Tennessee Jed. Yeah, I got two out of five on that one. I'll be honest with you. The kick, this is Rogers. And Rogers bottled up. He put it on the ground. Came loose. They're going to rule that a fumble. Did not hear the whistle go before the ball came loose. And Mitchell Thornton recovers the loose ball for Tennessee. It'll stay Volunteer football.
Well, Dayreek Rogers, another one of those freshmen. I think he was down. Don't you, Mark? Look to me like he was down right there. But you talk about the senior receivers for Tennessee. Yeah, he's down. His elbow was down. Gerald Jones, Denarius Moore. They have a couple young freshmen. And Dayreek Rogers, and we've also mentioned Justin Hunter. Kind of the future.
A pitch to Poole. And Poole gets a few. Let's check in with Dari in the studio.
Guys, over on ESPN2, you get a Big Five battle in Philadelphia. Villanova, Temple on the campus of the Villanova Wildcats. Temple, though, out quickly. Juan Fernandez for three. The Owls leading by two late in the first. Now, after that game on ESPN2, the Connecticut women go for their 90th straight win. They are at Stanford, the last team that beat UConn back in 2008.
All right, Dari. Not sure I see that upset happening there. Pass complete to Gerald Jones at about the 42-yard line. That's where his forward progress is going to be marked, and that's going to be enough for a Tennessee first down.
So far, pass protection, not really an issue for Tennessee. You know, they came in 112th in the country in sacks allowed. Their big thing, can they survive at the line of scrimmage? These freshmen, there's three freshmen right there. 64, 72, and 70. Think about 3-4 years from now if those kids continue to develop in this program.
Ray on the mark. Out of contact, but no flag thrown. The pass complete to Torin Poole. Kevin Reddick with the stop there and a gain of four on the play.
You know, Torin Poole's an interesting guy. You know, he had 86 yards in 08, 85 in 09. He comes on this year and has 994 yards. You know, there was a point last year. They wanted to put him in the game at the end against Memphis. He wouldn't go in the game. So another guy that's taken advantage of the change and really excelled.
Second and five. Is his understudy. Neal. Rajon Neal gets about one on the play. And yeah, getting back to that situation, Bob, where they asked Poole to go in the game late last year in that blowout against Memphis. He says that he respectfully, quote unquote, declined to go in. And a lot of his teammates understood his point of view, thinking that he should have gotten a lot more reps last year. Of course, he was playing behind Montario Hardesty and Bryce Brown and David Oku, who's now number two.
Yeah, but that's not the way to show it. If you should get more reps, play a little better in practice and earn those reps. Don't just deny the coaches.
Even in garbage time, as the pass incomplete to Jones.
You can't do that.
If it's 66-10 and the coach asks you to go in with 2 minutes to go, have you ever been in that kind of situation where a player said something like that?
I might have been in it once. I wouldn't have been in it twice.
Okay. Enough said. Fourth and four coming up. And Chad Cunningham into punt from his own 34. A great punt. Unfortunately for Tennessee, it bounces all the way into the end zone for a 52-yard punt. So the coach says, no matter what, you got to get back in the game. All right. Chew on that with some popcorn, and we'll be right back.
Home, the place where memories are created. Whether you're buying your first home, raising your family, or settling down to enjoy life, Franklin American Mortgage is a name you can trust. We give our customers the service and dependability they deserve when financing their home. Whether working directly with Franklin American Mortgage or one of our industry partners, we are committed to your dream of home ownership. Franklin American Mortgage. Let our service guide you home.
The perfect place to cure your winter blues has affordable entertainment and special event packages. Break away this winter to Gaylord Opryland Resort, Nashville's premier resort destination, where it's always 72 degrees and sunny inside our tropical atriums. Enjoy award-winning restaurants, live entertainment at the Grand Ole Opry or General Jackson Showboat, and our luxurious spa all in one place. There's no better time to escape to Gaylord Opryland, so plan your Nashville getaway today. For the best values and packages, visit GaylordOpryland.com.
With the Venture Card from Capital One, we get double miles on every purchase, so we earned a trip to Vegas twice as fast. And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang.
Is Caesar home?
We get double miles every time we use our card, no matter what we're buying.
Thank you very much.
It's hard to beat double miles.
If anyone objects, let them speak now, forever hold their...
Get the Venture Card from Capital One, Money Magazine's best rewards card if you aim to rack up airline miles.
What's in your wallet? Cannonball!
Excuse me. For change.
It's nice to know you can trust people. State Farm is counting on it. They want you to talk to your neighbors, then call a State Farm agent, find out how you can get discounts up to 40%. See, State Farm insures 40 million drivers. That's more than Geico and Progressive combined. 40 million drivers, more savings, and discounts up to 40%. So call an agent at 1-800-STATE-FARM or go online.
ESPN College Football, the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, is brought to you by Franklin American Mortgage Company. Let our service guide you home. Gaylord Hotels, a Gaylord Entertainment Company. And the Capital One Venture Card, what's in your wallet?
Look at what's happening downtown in Nashville, Tennessee, where they had the Battle of the Bands last night. And right now it's a 10-7 game. North Carolina with the lead. And speaking of North Carolina and Music City, U.S. area, some of the more popular songs with Carolina is their themes. I'll take that last one, Raise Up, with Petey Pablo. Here's Drawn trying the right side of that offensive line and met at the 23-yard line. A good stick by Hughes. Gain of 3 on the play.
There's a young defensive lineman, Montori Hughes. This Tennessee defensive line, not as big, not as physical, not as much depth as you've seen in the past. Moving forward in this program, they're going to have to recruit some more defensive linemen here at Tennessee. A great play right there by a young sophomore.
7-6 looks better than 6-6, I guess, like you said, when it comes to recruiting. 2nd and 7 coming up. Bates underneath, completes it at the 26-yard line. Nice catch by Joshua Adams, who picks up 4, brought down by Brewer.
Well, key so far for Carolina, Sean Drone, the senior, 86 yards. You see the chart right there. Really had one big run in this game. Last year, missed the last 4 games of the year because of a shoulder injury. Carolina's lost 4 tailbacks, taking advantage tonight, being the go-to guy.
He's got 86 of their 121. Drone with the first down across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Yeah, 2 years ago, actually, in 2008, he led the team in rushing. And last year started a bunch of games, but you talk about the carousel of tailbacks this year with Johnny White, who dislocated his clavicle against Florida State. There was some speculation about him being able to play. That wasn't the case. Anthony Elzey failed to meet his academic obligations and was unable to play in this bowl game, and then they going to sit Ryan Houston. Next man up. Yates brought down at the 29. Terrell Vereen came up to make the stop. Yates kind of slipped as well and helped him out. A loss of 5.
Yeah, you're going to see TJ Yates slip right here. And this kid's seen it all. You talk about tough skin. 44 starts. And you know what happens? It's kind of like coaching. They get tired of you a little bit. You know, he's been around there for 44 starts at Carolina. They always want to know who the backup is, who is the next quarterback. All in all, this kid has really had an excellent career. And I think has a shot to make it in the NFL.
Completes this pass underneath to Jones. White Jones stays on his feet and is brought down at about the 36-yard line. Yeah, getting back to Yates and what he's had to endure being in the critical spotlight. He was at a basketball game last year in Chapel Hill, a home game, and they showed his face up on the video board, and the fans actually started booing. There were some social network sites that he had to feel the bad side of the angers from some of the fans, and even had a 12-year-old kid that wrote him a letter, told him to quit.
Yeah, what he is, though, he's a guy that's an authentic leader. There's no phoniness. He leads players by example, and that's why I have so much respect for him.
Stands in, but misfires that time. That pass a little bit hot, intended for Ryan Taylor. And it's fourth down coming up for the Tar Heels.
Tell you, this Tennessee defense now started out a little shaky, but they've only given up 13 points a game over the last four. They seem to have settled in. Justin Wilcox, the young defensive coordinator, in his first year after coming over from Boise State, playing pretty good right now.
Guy whose name has surfaced with speculation regarding some other defensive coordinator jobs, namely Texas.
You're saying he can keep that orange and go from orange to orange?
It's a burnt orange, right? Tennessee brought a little heat that time, but didn't get to it. And Anthony Anderson watches it bounce out of bounds. Right around the 20-yard line. 10-7, North Carolina with the lead. Tyler Bray going to have the reins to the offense when we come back, and we'll give you a little bit of a history lesson as well. Stick around.
The 2011 All-State Sugar Bowl, Tuesday on ESPN.
If there's any way I can get a few extra dollars, for me it really does matter.
Agent LeBlanc is next to the Nickel Diner in L.A. offering second looks.
I did my own taxes, and that's probably why I didn't get no money back.
If you take another peek, you never know what you can get.
We want to get back every dime due.
Tonight, we reveal the results.
$300!
$431.
$2,000.
It's their money. We're just bringing it back home. H&R Block, never settle for less.
The Barclays Premier League is on ESPN2.
Well, that's an explosive hit from Nani. Wow, that's tremendous.
Saturday, every win is crucial as Manchester United looks to fend off upstart West Brom and keep pace among the league leaders. The Barclays Premier League. West Brom versus Manchester United. Saturday at 7:30 a.m. Eastern on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com.
Every day is so wonderful, and suddenly it's hard to breathe. Now and then I get insecure from all the pain. I'm so ashamed.
Would it be okay if I sat here?
I am beautiful, no matter
what. Is she serious? Whatever. New girl.
I am beautiful in every single way. Yes, words can't bring me down. So don't you bring
reaching
me down.
Out. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Condridge Holloway is a talented runner and passer, but his greatest talent is his scrambling and a flair for the dramatic.
Your life was surrounded by lines on a football field, but the imaginary ones would probably be some of the toughest.
Segregation now, segregation tomorrow, and segregation forever.
Well, on February 20th, ESPN will premiere The Color Orange, the Condridge Holloway story. Directed by country music singer and Tennessee native Kenny Chesney. You see Condridge Holloway there in 72. He became the first African-American starting quarterback in the SEC. They went on to lead Tennessee to three straight bowl appearances and later had an outstanding career in the Canadian Football League. And I can tell you that as a youth growing up in Toronto, I had a whole bunch of Condridge Holloway jerseys. Pass complete. Torn Poole. Brought down by Zach Brown. And Condridge Holloway had some great years playing up in the CFL, Bob, with a former Notre Dame quarterback, Tom Clements, who was his backup at times. And really a great success story.
And Kenny Chesney, I don't know if you saw that documentary special Kenny Chesney did, talking about high school football, playing high school football in East Tennessee. Interviewed a lot of coaches from around the country. Just a great piece on what high school football, Tennessee football, football in the South means.
Shapes up to be a good piece. Let's go back to Dari in the studio.
Guys, coming up on the H&R Block Halftime Report, we will take a look at what happened at Yankee Stadium. Controversy with Syracuse and Kansas State. Also look at the two quarterbacks leading the final game of the night, Jake Locker and Taylor Martinez, as the Holiday Bowl approaches. And also news out of Columbus concerning the five Buckeyes suspended for five games next season. It's all coming up. Mark and Lou going to join me at the halftime.
All right, Dari, back to your third and four. About 3 minutes to go. Gray shows he can escape. Tipped and incomplete. Brought down by Zach Brown. It was Zach Brown that tipped the pass, actually. Zach Brown had that interception and the return to set up the field goal on the last possession by North Carolina.
And again, Quentin Copels, I think one of the best defensive tackles in the country. It's 6'6", 275, stepping up in there with great pressure again.
Or Searcy right there on his own 30-yard line. Chad Cunningham punting. A little over 42 a punt on the season. Gets off a high towering spiral. Searcy all the way back at the 23. And good coverage that time by the Volunteers. They bring him down at the 27. A 49-yard punt. About five on the return. Nashville, aglow at night. We'll be back right after this.
See you in Nashville.
It was 1975. My professor at Berkeley asked me if I wanted to change the world. I said, sure. Well, let's grow some algae. And that's what started it. ExxonMobil and Synthetic Genomics have built a new facility to identify the most productive strains of algae. Algae are amazing little critters. They secrete oil, which we could turn into biofuels. They also absorb CO2. We're hoping to supplement the fuels that we use in our vehicles and to do this at a large enough scale to someday help meet the world's energy demands.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Do woodchucks chuck wood?
Hey, you dang woodchucks! Quit chucking my wood!
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It was just gigantic.
It was humongous.
Enormous, huge bill.
That's actually when we switched to Vonage.
The service is great.
I don't see any difference with the call quality.
More, I can just pick up the phone, call
as many family members as I want. Ugh, why did I not do this earlier? I'm Laura Pruden, and this was my last bill
before I switched to Vonage.
Switch your home phone service to Vonage and get unlimited U.S. and international calling for $14.99 a month. Now without an annual contract. Go to Vonage.com or call now.
Hey, New Year's Day got a great one. Andy Dalton leads undefeated TCU against Wisconsin's heralded backfield in the Rose Bowl game presented by Vizio. Coverage starting at 4:30 Eastern time. The Rose Bowl also available on ESPN Radio, online at ESPN3.com. And on your phone, Bob, what do you think of that? That huge offensive line of Wisconsin.
Hey, horned frogs in the Rose Bowl. That sounds as different as horned frogs going to the Big East, right? Yeah. That should be a good matchup.
They're both shot. Thrown, brought down right around the line of scrimmage by Ruvaez.
You know, we talked about today, getting ready for this game, how similar these teams are. Not just the off-the-field stories of bouncing back, getting to a bowl game, but on the field, almost identical. We're talking about 136 to 136 right now, total yardage in this football game.
Second and 10. Yates. Tipped up and incomplete. Harmlessly at the 43, Jansen Jackson was the closest one to it.
Well, Jansen Jackson has bounced back from that missed tackle early in the football game. They really like this young free safety. He's kind of the eraser back there in the middle of the field. Really, really talented. Another third down and long.
Up incomplete and no flags on the play, and Derek Dooley is really feeling it right now with his defense. LaMarcus Thompson was there to break up the pass intended for Eric Highsmith. You know it's serious, Bob, when the headset comes off.
Well, they're playing really good defense right now and have a chance to kind of win this field position thing as this game goes back and forth between these punters. Again, punt returns, always a concern, securing the football for Tennessee.
He goes punting. Punting into the wing, it gets caught up a little bit. And the ball is loose, but there's a flag down. I'm not sure that Anthony Anderson was given enough space to make the catch on the 33-yard punt.
Yeah, Darius Lipford, I think, number 23, obviously got there early. Just a freshman.
Catch interference, number 23 of the kicking team. 15 yards, so we call the foul.
Another example, we said earlier, all those suspensions. There's a freshman, Darius Lipford, playing as a freshman in this football game. Under normal circumstances in a normal season, he may not even be on the field. So that's a byproduct, again, of both these football teams playing with a lot of youth.
Gives Tennessee pretty good starting field position here with 1:45 to go in the first half and a timeout remaining. Carolina with two. Bray on the out and out. But he's out of bounds. The freshman went high for it, Hunter, but couldn't get the feet down. Matt Merletti back there defending.
Yeah, a little double move. Good decision by Tyler Bray just to throw it up. Look at the vertical jump by Justin Hunter at 6'5". Remember we were down on the field before the game. What did I say to you about him?
Number 11 is really good looking on the hoof.
Yeah, and the longest arms I've seen. You combine those long arms with that kind of vertical jump.
Bruce Pearl might want to take a look at him. Second and 10. Ray going up top again. Touchdown, Vols. Rodgers.
Well, if you're a Vol fan, you've seen a freshman wide receiver, number 11, go up and make an unbelievably athletic move. Now you see a freshman quarterback hit another freshman, Derek Rodgers. I think the future has potential to be pretty bright in Knoxville.
The future's coming about a little earlier than maybe some people thought behind number 8, Tyler Bray. And his cast of precocious freshmen.
You can see why they've become a quarterback wide receiver team and made the philosophical switch. That's one freshman. That is a beautifully thrown ball over the top of Mywan Jackson. And I noticed yesterday in film study, Tyler Bray puts more air under the deep ball than almost any quarterback I've seen.
Tell you what, he may be slight. He may be very angular. And at just 210, but man, he can sling it with his 16th touchdown pass this season and his second tonight.
Let's go back and watch the altitude he gets on this throw. I mean, it's off the screen for a while, but that is a beautifully thrown football.
The freshman with a great effort. Derek Rodgers with the catch and the touchdown.
Harrelson on the return. And Harrelson out over the 25 to the 27-yard line. North Carolina has a minute 25 to go here in the first half. Down by four with a couple of timeouts remaining.
It's interesting. You look at that freshman quarterback over there, Tyler Bray. Hasn't been here long enough to feel any kind of pressure. I know he's a California laid-back guy, according to everyone. On the other hand, you have TGA Yates that's seen it all. I mean, what a contrast of a grinder guy that's been beat up and threw it all. And then you got this kid from California. He's just starting out. He doesn't even know what pressure is yet. He'll learn, though, as he goes through his 4 years in Tennessee.
Yates' turn now. He completes the pass at about the 35 to Ryan Taylor. Taylor reliable in the wake of Zach Benalto's injury. Second and four.
See if T.J. Yates now with two timeouts gets something going.
Down the middle of the field, finds his man at the 48-yard line. The aforementioned Ryan Taylor making another catch. 103 to go and a couple of timeouts remaining still. An 18-yard game. Incomplete and tipped up, almost intercepted. That stops the clock with 53 seconds to go.
Great effort by Malik Jackson, transfer from USC. Took advantage of the transfer rule with USC's probation. That's a great effort right there. Guy playing inside as a defensive tackle, very undersized, but has some suddenness, has some quickness to him.
Second and 10. Yates steps up, completes it at the 38-yard line. Wilson making the catch. 42 and 41 now to go in the first half. Still got those two timeouts. 9-yard pickup. Yates has a man. Touchdown, Carolina. Highsmith.
Well, the old Grizzly veteran, T.J. Yates, responded to the young freshman. His ability to scramble to his left, keep that play alive. Eric Highsmith beat Prentice Wagner, but really, T.J. Yates and his ability to scramble right there. But you talk about responding. These teams have responded all year. It'll be interesting to see who wins out.
The extra point good, and for Yates, that was his 19th touchdown pass of the season and the 58th of his career.
Again, this is creativity, creating a play. See him scrambling to his left right here? That puts a lot of stress on the secondary. And you see Eric Highsmith get in behind Prentice Wagner. Boy, that was a two-minute drill run to its finest right there by T.J. Yates.
Bob, they didn't even have to use any of their two timeouts to put it in the end zone. A couple of quarterbacks really making indelible marks on this game here in the first half. The freshman and the senior, look at their comparative numbers.
And it's really interesting, isn't it, how even though one's a senior, one's a freshman, these teams so similar in that they are quarterback, wide receiver, tight end kind of teams. It's not really about the running game. So you have these two guys right here, center stage. One of them with so much invested at Carolina. The other one just starting. Sometimes there's something about that guy that's just kind of casual and cool, right?
Yeah.
That just goes out there and lets it rip. That's kind of what Tyler Bray is right now.
A couple of Tennessee people, Bob, comparing him, Bray, to Eric Ainge in his freshman year. Guy that we saw as a freshman.
I thought you were going to go to that guy at the Indianapolis Colts right there. I was getting ready to say,
not
easy
yet,
now, easy.
David Oku on the kickoff return. Well, let's take a look at Tyler Bray on the sidelines. They talked about at times him not having the requisite amount of emotion, but that's pretty good right there. Not so California laid back there, so a little show of emotion.
Tennessee going to just take this thing to halftime right now.
Interesting first half between a couple of teams that came in pretty evenly matched. Both have had their share of tumultuous times, and 30 minutes into this 13th edition of the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, it's 17-14, and Kara's downstairs with Coach Dooley.
Coach, it was a really eventful last couple minutes of that half. What left the biggest impact in your opinion?
Well, we finally made a big play down the field. We're not executing the pass game very well, doing the simple things and making it hard. And then we just lost contain on the quarterback in 2 minutes and let a guy free man-to-man coverage.
It was such an evenly played first half. What's going to make the difference in the second half?
We just have to execute better. We're playing pretty good defense. We've given up two big plays. That's what's killed us. But we got to execute better on offense. We're not executing the way we're capable of executing.
We look forward to the second half. Thanks,
all right,
Coach.
Thank you.
Guys.
Yeah, good point, Kara. Good second half. Intriguing second half coming up. Our score at halftime, Carolina leading 17-14, courtesy of that last touchdown pass by T.J. Yates. And right now, let's head to the H&R Block Halftime Report. On the banks of the Cumberland River, welcome back to Nashville, Tennessee, in the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. T.J. Yates, the quarterback, got that live arm and showed it off towards the end of the first half of play. And the freshman quarterback, Bray, for Tennessee. Boy, it's been 4 wins in a row and counting. Mark Jones, Bob Davey, Kara Capuano down on the field joining us in just a few moments. Bob, coming into this game, we heard it was going to be a sellout. Pretty much a home game for Tennessee. Two pretty evenly matched teams. It's pretty much lived up to the billing, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, this is what a bowl game's supposed to be. You know, there may be some cynics out there that, number one, say there's too many bowl games with 35. They may look at this and say, hey, 7-5 against 6-6. What are we talking about? But there's a lot of intrigue. I mean, both these teams, the two stories, coming back from big setbacks during the season. And then you've got these two young, one young quarterback, one old quarterback, and it's turned into a passing game. I mean, in that second quarter, North Carolina ran for 8 yards. Tennessee ran for 2 yards. It's all on these quarterbacks in the second half.
Hey, let's take a look at our game track brought to you by Nationwide Insurance. A couple of big plays. The first one, the explosion by Sean Drone. A 58-yard scamper for the touchdown. He had 93 yards rushing in the first half. And Yates throwing a touchdown pass right there to Highsmith. And then the Tennessee freshman, Tyler Bray, 13-27 in the first half. To Derek Rogers, another freshman who says, yes, I got the belt right now. And North Carolina's going to have possession here to start the third quarter. Yates playing in the last two quarters of his collegiate career. From the 3-yard line, Searcy. And Denars Searcy takes it over the 27-yard line. Let's take a look at the first half stats brought to you by American Airlines. Tennessee with a couple of turnovers, Carolina with one.
And really, Carolina with that big drive right there at the end of the first half, or this game statistically would be dead even. But really, the rushing yards a little bit deceiving. All those rushing yards were actually in the first quarter. So it's turned into a passing game.
From the 26. Hand off on the end around to Harrelson. And Harrelson makes a couple of people miss. Taking out to the 37-yard line. That's good enough for a first down of 11 yards. Reves makes the stop, and we have an attendance record here. An LP record of 69,000 plus.
Yeah, you see that one little pocket right over here of blue. Other than that, it's like being in Knoxville.
Just 2.5 hours away. First and 10. Drone brought down from behind, but showed a nice burst across midfield and into Tennessee territory at the 48-yard line. Wagner makes the stop at a 14-yard gain.
Yeah, good block by the center, Cam Holland, right there. And that's a gaping hole. Good patience again by Sean Drone to just let that hole open up.
Hey, Drone with the second 100-yard rushing game of the season. A guy that, I guess it's, he's the fourth on the four deep. Step it up. Yates completes it. Drone makes the catch, but stopped immediately. Hey, Carol, what kind of adjustments did Butch Davis talk about at half?
Well, on offense specifically, he wants to see the Tar Heels run the ball better. We've seen that so far this drive. On defense, he wants the guys in the secondary to do a better job getting on top of the receivers. He said they have allowed some big plays to those rangy balls. And most importantly, poise, self-confidence, self-discipline. He pointed to the 5 penalties for 45 yards in the first half.
Right now, they're looking at second down and 10. Which Davis told Kerry they want to run it better, and that time a gain of 3 on the ground by Sean Drone.
You know, we've talked a lot about Butch Davis and the job he's done, but this assistant coaching staff at Carolina, John Shoup, the offensive coordinator, coached a long time in the NFL. On the offensive side, Everett Withers on defense. You see John Shoup right there. Think of the players they have lost on offense. Kind of an ever-changing lineup. I tell you, the assistant coaches have risen to the challenge.
Yeah, they lost Greg Little, who's an NFL-type receiver. 3rd and 7. Yates incomplete behind his intended receiver, Nelson Hurst. And it's 4th and long coming up for North Carolina.
Boy, TJ backpedaling a little bit out of there, never really set his feet because of the pressure. Jaquez Smith, a freshman defensive lineman. TJ Yates would love to have that one back.
Instead, CJ Fiegel's coming in to punt. He'll set up on his own 40-yard line, and Anthony Anderson standing on his own 10. 5th punt of the night for Fiegel's.
No, TJ Yates hasn't been as accurate. Missed some throws tonight that I think he normally makes.
Anderson watches it go over his head, and North Carolina's going to down this right around the 5-yard line. Talked about the coaching staff, Bob, and Everett Withers is what it was looking like pregame, firing up his troops.
Let's go.
Can't imagine how many sessions he's been in one-on-one with defensive players. I mean, their defensive lineup coming into the season, I think they were 9th in the country last year in total defense. Without a doubt, if they would have kept their roster intact, would have been the best defense in the country this year. I mean, they lost 2 first-round draft choices, defensive linemen that never played it down. Everett Withers spent 6 seasons here at the Tennessee Titans. He has been a big part of this football team staying together.
And Butch Davis was really effusive in his praise of his entire coaching staff and being able to help him hold things together during the times of crisis this year.
I mean, they lost John Blake, the defensive line coach, after the LSU game. Now think of all the different dynamics that come with that. They not only lost players, they lost the coach.
1st and 10 for Tennessee, and they're going to run it. Out to the 13-yard line, that's Poole, and Kara has more on Everett Withers.
Well, guys, I saw something I don't usually see waiting to talk to Coach Davis outside the Tar Heels locker room. Coach Withers actually left about 5 minutes before the rest of the assistant coaches to take the elevator up to the box. One of the guys said, hey, wait for us. And he said, no, I just need to go think a minute. And he ran ahead of them just to have a moment to himself to get ready for the second half. It was interesting.
One half to go, and never too late to gather your thoughts. 2nd and 2. and Bray brought down, sacked at the 4-yard line by Quan Sturdivant. That's the third sack of the year for him.
Yeah, now we know why he got away by himself. He said, you know what? I'm going to bring Quan Sturdivant on that blitz. Again, a young offensive line. Carolina not really a big pressure defense.
Third and long, third and 10. A loss of 8 on that last play. Way out of the end zone. It's ruled complete. Right near the first down marker, and he gets the first down. Boy, Tyler Bray found Gerald Jones for a pickup of 13.
You know, you hear the term pocket presence so much. Watch Bray step up in the pocket. Just avoids that outside rush right there of Dante Page Moss. You know, some guys, Mark, doesn't matter how athletic you are, they just feel things, and they have instincts of people around them. Kind of eyes in the back of their head. This guy is one of those guys. He feels that rush.
Back to pass again. Incomplete, intended for Jones again. That time Jones met by Sturdivant. Boy, you think of Jones right there, who we're looking at on the screen, number 4, Bob. We saw him as a freshman. Remember the old, was it the G-gun formation?
Yeah.
Just really underscores the amount of changes these players have seen.
And like I said earlier, these seniors didn't sign up for this. They didn't sign up for coming to Tennessee playing for 3 different head coaches, 3 different strength coaches, 3 different philosophies. So, yeah, Gerald Jones has seen it all.
Second and 10. He completes it to Stocker. And Stocker knocked out of bounds. And what a week it's been for Luke Stocker. The 6'6 senior actually had the courage to ask his head coach, Derek Dooley, Bob, Coach, how do you feel about pushing practice back a little bit so I could get married?
Got married Friday before last. What time did he get married?
I don't know who planned that.
If you're going to put that story out now, I want details.
You got to know that there's
the details down to the last tee.
You got to know that there's a bowl game out there somewhere. Pass complete to Jones, and Jones makes the catch at the 36. Hey,
I got a picture of Vince Dooley sitting at home right now watching this game saying, hey, it's an aerial circus. I mean, there's not even a sniff of running that football. You know, Vince was a guy now. He liked that big eye tailback. Run that football downhill, but you have to love Derek Dooley. He wants to run the football more. But they are not geared right now to do that. And, I mean, they're throwing it every down.
Gain of 11 on the play, first and 10. Play fake and play. Plenty of time, and wisely throws it away. So is Vince Dooley sitting at home in that couch you were talking about saying, can the quarterback run? Is he still asking that question?
Yeah, I saw him. I told that story to Derek this week, but I saw Vince Dooley on the field before the Georgia Tech game just a couple weeks ago,
right.
The last game of the year. And that's the day Tennessee had beat Kentucky to end up 6-6. And I said, Vince, it looks like Derek has found himself a quarterback in Tyler Bray. And he said, yeah, but the kid can't run a lick. And Derek kind of laughed at that and said, well, he threw for 350 yards. But no question, Vince Dooley likes to run that football.
Second down and 10. Pass complete. But that was Rodgers that stepped out of bounds prior to getting the first down. Gain of about 4 on the play. Zach Rodgers, another one of those young players, this one a sophomore. 3rd and 6 coming up for the Volunteers. Right between a couple of teams, border rivals that haven't played since 1961.
Big tight end Luke Stocker flexed out right here.
And that snap came a little bit late.
I tell you, young Bray better watch himself now.
Show a little emotion.
Spiking that football, yeah. I mean, we saw a guy penalized at the end of the Kansas State game today.
Now, I got to ask you. You saw that call. You know I'm going to ask you, partner. You know me well. What would you have done if you were that official? I mean, it ended up costing them the game. It was a big factor. At the very
truthfully,
least.
Yeah. I think right there in that situation, I would have warned the kids sternly that, you know, I could have called it right there. Just the last play like that in a bowl game.
It's one of the things I'd change in sports because I, you know, peruse that article in ESPN, the magazine.
Yeah, but you want to let it get out of control. I'm saying just a one-time deal.
Well, an offensive line couldn't protect Bray that time, and they sacked the quarterback. Paige Moss lost his hat on the play.
Well, we had Dante Paige Moss from the outside, and we had Quentin Copels from the inside. Both helmets are off. Wow.
Paige Moss took a hit from his teammate.
Yeah, Paige Moss Copels. And Copels met at the quarterback.
Paige Moss didn't have his helmet on when he got hit. He'll have a bump on his head.
Yeah, you see it right there.
He got hit.
And when you watch Carolina, you see why the expectations. Because you're looking right now, Dante Paige Moss, Quentin Copels, they're NFL caliber defensive linemen. That's a nasty shot right there. But you add in Marvin Austin, Robert Quinn. That's two more, probably first-round defensive linemen.
Yeah, you add in that, and all of a sudden that 7-5 is maybe a 9-3. And tell you what, for Paige Moss, he'll pick up a half a sack or maybe a whole one, giving him 6.5 on the season. If it's Copels, I'm going to donate my half to him for taking that hit. Back after this.
Six strings and a dream. That's all some folks bring to Nashville. And most times that ain't enough. But when the strings and the dream line up just right, something magical happens. And more often than not, it happens at the Grand Ole Opry. Come see the show, Made Country Music Fest.
For discounted Night at the Opry packages, including tickets and accommodations at Gaylord Opryland Resort, call now.
This holiday season, why buy a copy when you can have the original? More powerful, more fuel-efficient engines, no-cost maintenance that can save you thousands. All designed to bring you joy. That's BMW. Find your original at the BMW Joy Sales Event now. And get a holiday credit of up to $2,500 with nothing down on most BMW models.
H&R Block is doing a second look at our taxes. So someone was in here this morning and left us some flyers.
I own a quilt store.
I don't like doing taxes. Numbers aren't my kind of thing. I'm really a people person.
You're going to carry inventory. You're going to have mileage.
There was a lot that I'd guessed at, and I have a feeling I guessed wrong.
Are you ready?
I think she's ready.
Oh, my gosh. It's 5,003.
H&R Block. Never settle for less.
Hardcore action goes to the next level.
Illegal weapons, gangs, drugs.
With alternate storylines.
I like girls.
Too hot for the big screen.
Jeez, sis.
You're a twin? Why don't you join us?
Robert Rodriguez presents Machete on Blu-ray.
Right now, the NCAA is building over 400,000 future professionals. And most of us will go pro in something other than sports.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Here's what happened a couple of moments ago on that sack when Dante Paige Moss and Quentin Copels met at the quarterback, Tyler Bray. Paige Moss took a hit on the side of the head, actually in the face from his teammate, And this was the scene during the commercial break. He's okay, but I got to believe, Bob, that hurts. That hurts.
See, he's kind of laughing about it. But pass protection, that's for Tennessee. That has been the problem with the young offensive line.
Cunningham with a high spiral. And Searcy calls for the fair catch right around the 30, a 42-yard punt, nothing on the return. Let's go downstairs to Kara for an update on Deontay Williams from that first half injury.
Well, guys, as predicted, he does have a break in his right fibula at the ankle. They have said it. He will travel back with the team tomorrow. But what an unfortunate end to a great senior season for him. Broken leg in the bowl game.
Some real sad irony about the way that transpired. And the whole season has been a real battle for North Carolina. First down and 10 for the Tar Heels at their own 30-yard line. Yates, under heated sack, back at the 22. Gerald Williams, the 6'3 senior, coming off the edge to make the tackle.
Yeah, great effort by Gerald Williams. Watch him come all the way around from the outside. T.J. Yates held onto the football a little long, tried to spin back out. But very good effort by the senior, Gerald Williams. Pass protection starting to break down for both teams right now.
Loss of 8 on the sack. Drone fumbles it, and Tennessee has it.
I thought he was down.
Herman Lathers made the stop, but they're going to rule it down.
Runner was down.
There's the call and third down coming up.
Yeah, on first look, just live, it looked to me he was down. See, Lathers, good effort from the backside. He was clearly down.
Gain of 5 on the play.
This crowd now a factor on third and long.
Yates moving the pocket. And throws it away. Fourth down coming up. And you talked about pass protection becoming an issue for both teams.
Exactly. I mean, it's pretty obvious now that it's pass first. Good pressure again. Malik Jackson, LaMarcus Thompson, the outside linebacker. And that's why the running game. At some point, you do have to slow that rush down and make them respect the run.
Torrin Poole has some skills right now. Anthony Anderson staying at his own 32. Eagles with the punt. Number 22, Anderson. And a nice return out to the 34-yard line. A 50-yard punt. 9 on the return from way, way up. It's still colored orange here in Nashville.
Home, the place where memories are created. Whether you're buying your first home, raising your family, or settling down to enjoy life, Franklin American Mortgage is a name you can trust. We give our customers the service and dependability they deserve when financing their home. Whether working directly with Franklin American Mortgage or one of our industry partners, we are committed to your dream of home ownership. Franklin American Mortgage. Let our service guide you home.
Thanks to the Venture Card from Capital One, we get double miles on every purchase, so we undertrip to New Orleans twice as fast. We get double miles every time we use our card, no matter what we're buying.
I'll take it.
And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang.
Fire!
It's hard to beat double miles.
Have you seen cards?
Get the Venture Card from Capital One, Money Magazine's best rewards card if you aim to rack up airline miles.
What's in your wallet?
Baby, 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 baby.
Oh, blue. Tie.
touched it. I touched the ball before it went out, coach.
Come on, Alex. The ref did not call that.
You gotta be kidding me, Alex.
It's a championship game. Talk to him, coach.
I touched it. It's their ball.
Don't foul them when they inbound. Team on three. One, two, three.
How's it going, Alex?
Sorry, coach.
Alex. Alex.
Good call.
Sportsmanship. Pass it on.
Brett. I touched the man.
ESPN College Football, the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, is brought to you by Franklin American Mortgage Company. Let our service guide you home. BMW, the ultimate driving machine, and the Capital One Venture Card. What's in your wallet?
Look at some of the festivities last night downtown here in Nashville at the Battle of the Bands competition. Told the winner was the city of Nashville. Well, the influx of visitors and a local infusion into the local economy. Under 6 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Gray complete at the 47 to Luke Stalker as we check in with Dari in the studio.
Mark, college basketball over on ESPN2. Villanova, Temple, Big Five battle. Temple beat Villanova, the only team in Villanova's first 21 games to knock them off a year ago, but this time it is Nova. How about 24 points for Corey Stokes? 40 seconds to go in that game. Now, Maya Moore in Connecticut try to stretch their win streak to 90 games at Stanford, the last team to beat them. Should this get going before Nova's over? Check it out on ESPNU, guys.
All right, Dari, a 14-yard pickup by Stalker. This is Rogers. Looks like the ball came loose.
I'm going to call that piece of fucking shit.
Boy, that was Quentin Copels on a great effort play, knocking that football out.
We got Denarius Moore holding his leg coming out of the pack.
Yeah, they come with the reverse again to the freshman Derek Rogers. Look at that hit by Copels. Watch this on the backside. Bang! I mean, that football clearly out. And Denarius Moore, who's had a quiet night tonight, comes up with the biggest play of the night for him.
Loss of three, and look who's back in the ballgame along with Quentin Copels, Dante Page Moss. Fixed up on the sidelines. Little shuffle pass complete to Torin Poole. And Poole gets about three on the play.
And that's now 38 passes, 14 runs on the night for Tennessee. But we talk about seniors. We talk about rewards for guys. Quentin Copels, although he's just a junior, that was a great effort play right there, knocking that football out from the backside.
Worthy of that team MVP award that he won, along with quarterback T.J. Yates. Third and 10. Complete, but short of the first down at the 49-yard line. Nice catch made by Gerald Jones, who slipped and fell. Picks up four. And it's fourth and a six coming up. Close game tonight, competitive game, three-point game, three lead changes, couple fumbles, and two sacks.
Players love playing defense in games where offenses become one-dimensional. And they really love when they become one-dimensional throwing the football, because that's where these defensive linemen just tee off.
Cersei calls for the fair catch, watches it bounce, and then Wisely gets out of the way, and it takes a Tennessee bounce all the way down to the 6-yard line. That came dangerously close to bouncing off of Cersei and becoming a live ball. A 42-yard punt, nothing on the return.
He was trying to get out of the way. Fortunately, he did.
Music calls us home. Music calls us
Josh Turner. See you in Nashville.
How about this one? It's almost the same thing.
No, it's not.
This one's great.
It's just as good as the one you wanted.
No, it's not.
That's the one. Great choice.
Don't settle for a copy when you can have the original. The ultimate driving machine. Yours now at the BMW Joy Sales Event. And get a holiday credit of up to $2,500 with nothing down on most BMW models.
I would love to have been a musician, but I knew that I was going to need a day job. We actually have a lot of scientists that play music. The creativity, the innovation, there's definitely a tie there. One thing our scientists are working on is carbon capture and storage, which could prevent CO2 from entering the atmosphere. We've just built a new plant to demonstrate how we can safely freeze out the CO2 from natural gas. It looks like snow. It's one way that we're helping provide energy with fewer emissions.
New Year's Day, ESPN brings you three SEC Big Ten bowl battles airing simultaneously across networks. At 1 on ABC, Urban Meyer makes his Florida coaching finale against Joe Pa's Nittany Lions in the Outback Bowl. At 1 on ESPN and ESPN3.com, Alabama and Michigan State battle in the Capital One Bowl. And at 1:30 on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com, it's Mississippi State, Michigan in the Progressive Gator Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week, New Year's Day on ABC, ESPN, and ESPN2.
They return, ABC's V, all new Tuesday, January 4th. You're watching ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
North Carolina leading Tennessee 17-14. The 13th edition of the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl here from Nashville. Well, Friday, Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN. Three games in all at noon. South Florida taking on Clemson in the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Then at 3:30, it's Georgia against Central Florida in the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. And at 7:30, South Carolina takes on Florida State in the Chick-fil-A Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN on Friday. And North Carolina with its worst starting field position of the night. Drone with a gain of about 2 on the play.
Something we've not seen in this game. Screen passes. You know, particularly a screen pass to the running back.
Any idea why?
No, I think it'd be a great call, particularly right now on second and long, even though you're backed up. But you're going to have to do something to slow down. And this is both teams. Slow down the pass run. You know, if you can't run it, find ways to be creative. Getting the ball to your running back in different ways.
The drone has already gone over 100 yards tonight. He takes the toss here. Nice cutback by Sean Drone. And Drone with a first down out to the 18-yard line. Picks up 11 on the play, filling in for Johnny White and Anthony Elzey. Sean Drone with a strong run. First down and 10 from the 18.
Been impressed with Sean Drum. Talked about him getting his opportunity tonight. There's Johnny White over there on the sidelines who really had a great year for Carolina. Then Anthony Elzey comes in late, ends up academically ineligible for this game.
Underneath, pass complete. Up and down hard goes Ryan Taylor. Gains about 11 yards and another first down. Under 2 minutes to go now in the third quarter. There's a flag down on the field.
I think it might be Malik Jackson on a blow to the quarterback.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Going ahead. Number 97. Defense.
Yeah, I thought Malik Jackson came in. Got his hand up on the helmet of Yates. Let's see right here. Oh, man. I guess he did get that. Wasn't quite as bad as I saw it or thought I saw it, but yeah, it was up there around that face mask. Boy, squandering away field position, Tennessee's defense.
TJ Yates sold it a little bit. First and 10.
Field position, such a key part of this game. Sean Drone able to get a run, convert the first down, then the penalty right here.
And another flag.
And this one's going to go against Carolina.
Ball start, number 13, offense.
That's Christian Wilson.
Still, first down.
Let's go back to Dari in the studio.
All right, guys, want to let everybody know over on ESPN2, you can see number one Connecticut going for their 90th consecutive win. They are at Stanford. Stanford ranked eighth in the country. The Cardinal, the last team to beat Geno Auriemma's Huskies. That was in the NCAA tournament back in 2008. We will keep you posted. 3-2 Stanford early.
First and 15 after the penalty. Reeds fires low at the 43, and it's incomplete. Intended for Dwight Jones. Second and 15. Tennessee looking for its first win against an FBS team this year with a record over 500.
Yeah, James Hurst right here is going to get away with a hold right here. Watch the inside move right there. That should have been a penalty right there.
Gates completes it over the middle at the 44. That's Drone as a receiver this time. And hey, New Year's night, ESPN delivers the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl as Connecticut Huskies take on the Bowl people and make their first appearance in a BCS bowl game. They take on Oklahoma in one of the most explosive offenses in college football. The Tostitos Fiesta Bowl on ESPN New Year's Day at 8:30 Eastern time.
Who's really been quiet tonight? Number 83, Dwight Jones. You're going to see him up at the top of the field.
Yates with time steps up. Fires complete at the 45-yard line. That's Ryan Taylor, who picks up 11.
A great job by T.J. Yates. You talk about stepping up in the pocket. Tennessee with great speed outside rushers. He stepped up and delivered that football to Ryan Taylor. Big third down conversion.
The offensive coordinator, Coach Shoup, says that T.J. Yates physically is one of the best he's ever seen with respect to not having to panic and showing some great skills.
Well, he's had a bunch of snaps in his career. It's going to come down to one last fourth quarter to see if he can finish out on a positive.
In the shadows of the Grand Ole Opry, a scoreless third quarter after a few fireworks in the first half. 15 minutes to go. We'll be back to Nashville right after this.
The 2011 Discover Arn Cole, Monday on ESPN.
Your home. It's more than a dream come true. For most, it's the single biggest investment you make. Now, more than ever, you need a lender you can trust. Franklin American Mortgage, committed to strength and stability in lending, where every relationship is built on service and integrity. Franklin American Mortgage, lending you can depend on.
This holiday season, why buy a copy when you can have the original? More powerful, more fuel-efficient engines, no-cost maintenance that can save you thousands. All designed to bring you joy. That's BMW. Find your original at the BMW Joy Sales Event now. And get a holiday credit of up to $2,500 with nothing down on most BMW models.
Excuse me. Your
change. It's nice to know you can trust people. State Farm is counting on it. They want you to talk to your neighbors, then call a State Farm agent, find out how you can get discounts up to 40%. See, State Farm insures 40 million drivers. That's more than Geico and Progressive combined. 40 million drivers, more savings, and discounts up to 40%. So call an agent at 1-800-STATE-FARM or go online.
The Barclays Premier League is on ESPN2.
Well, that's an explosive hit from Nani.
Every win is crucial as Man U looks to fend off West Brom. Saturday at 7:30 a.m. Eastern on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com.
Sunday starts here. The guys tell you what to expect as the playoff picture comes into focus.
Everything just points to them winning.
They could screw up the whole thing for themselves.
Then explore the NFL's oldest rivalry. Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Hits throughout the course of the night. And the 13th edition of the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. North Carolina leading by three as we begin the fourth quarter of play. The final 15 minutes for both these teams. Tennessee trying to make it five in a row to end the season. And North Carolina trying to improve to 8-5 on the reverse. It's Boyd. Still on his feet and now ruled out of bounds.
Well, Jay Boyd is the fastest guy on this Carolina football team. You can see John Shoup getting creative in the running game. And North Carolina, I mean, they've rushed for 135 yards so far in this football game compared to Tennessee's seven. So they have had a little more balance.
From the 38. Drone falls down just shy of the 35-yard line. Got about two on the play.
Been an impressive drive by Carolina. You know, you think back, this drive started on, what, about the 5-6-yard line. Drone made a run. Tight end Ryan Taylor made a catch. The roughing the passer penalty on Malik Jackson. And here's the play action.
Looking up top. Lets it go. Has a man. What's the call? Picked off.
Jansen Jackson. He missed the tackle on the first series of the game, but he's come back and competed. He just outcompeted Eric Seismith, number 88.
His fifth interception of the year, and what a play by Jackson. They went to the ground. Tough to tell who actually had it. Until there.
Boy, we said these teams are so close in every aspect. That kind of typified what this season has been and these two teams. Jansen Jackson out-muscling Eric Highsmith for that football.
Interception. The play is under further review.
And, you know, Jackson, a big story for Tennessee. You know, after they wrote the final exams a couple of weeks ago, he had to return home to Louisiana to resolve some personal issues, and it still remains an issue as to what the nature of it is, but they decided they're going to keep it in the family. Play under review right now.
Oh, he's got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was, I guess the question, did he have possession of that football right there before he went out of bounds?
I think
he does.
The other angle showed that he actually did have it.
You can see the back judge was shielded right there. Not a great angle to see it, but it was ruled an interception on the field. I think that's going to stand.
Well, he really just out-wrestled Eric Highsmith for that football. And there's a look at Jansen, whose father is actually the interim head coach right now at Miami, Ohio, Lance Guidry. The two of them said that they're going to work it through, that Jansen is going to work through his personal issues. That's back in Louisiana. Second team All-SEC selection. A big play.
T.J. Yates underthrew that football just a little bit. Allowed Jansen to get back into play.
He's got it there.
Yeah, it was rolling. See, right there on his belly, though, it wasn't totally secure. I mean, that's the only issue. But again, since it was ruled an interception, I do think it will stand. But it is close.
Has to be indisputable video evidence to overturn the call on the field.
Again, a Big Ten crew working this game. Big Ten instant replay. Mark, I think these two teams could play 10 times. I think it would be 5-5. Now, you add the 35 players that North Carolina has lost in some way or another during the course of the season. You could see why North Carolina, this was the year. And the expectation, you know, they played in the Chick-fil-A against LSU because of those high expectations. They were picked to play in that football game. But I tell you, the guys that are left standing from Carolina are still talented, and they have shown a lot of heart.
If it stands, it's the eight.
Review, the ruling is confirmed.
That's the first interception thrown by T.J. Yates in his last 89 passes. But it comes at a pivotal time with just under 14 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter.
You have to credit Tennessee's defense. I mean, Carolina's made some plays, but they've hung in there and allowed this young offense that really only has 227 yards tonight to get another opportunity.
Ajon Neal in the backfield. They're going to pass, though. Gray throws up a duck, which harmlessly goes out of bounds. And let's go back to Dari in the studio.
Guys, we're going to continue to track UConn's 90-game winning streak, going for 91 at Stanford, and the Cardinal came out on fire. 4 of 5 from downtown. Lindy LaRock, 6 points. Stanford was up 13, currently up 9 on the Huskies. 11.5 to go on ESPN2.
Well, that's going to be a personal foul.
There's a flag on the last play.
Roughing the passer on Quentin Copels. Little double move. Helmet to helmet.
Been one of the emphases all year long in college football.
And there isn't any question that defensive players have to change their aiming point, and they have to think about it.
North Carolina with 7 penalties for a total of 65 yards. Neal on the handoff. That's how Neal brought down at about the 39.
And that's a good call.
That's a gain of 5.
Good block by Jerrod Shaw, the left offensive guard. Watch him right here. Carolina getting up the field. He's just going to go ahead and take 91 inside. That was a very athletic move on Tydrick Powell. By Jerrod Shaw at about 335 pounds.
See Rajon Neal getting a bunch of reps here in the backfield. Gray under some heat. And he wisely throws it away. There's a flag thrown at the 48 as well. He was outside of that tackle box.
I don't think it's that. I think it was the receiver and defensive back locked up over there. Number 21, Denoris Searcy.
He's going to go against Tennessee.
My pass interference. Offense, number 81. At the 15-yard previous spot, will repeat. Second down.
That's Rivera.
And Michael Rivera, the transfer from Oregon.
Backup tight end in the game on an offensive pass interference. You don't see that very often on an incomplete pass where the ball was thrown. There it is right there. Yeah, he's blocking downfield. I'm not sure what he's thinking. He looked like he thought it was going to be a screen pass.
Get the wrong call. There's a penalty situation.
Boy.
It's all the way back to the 25. Bray fumbles the snap. And this one implodes. Now back to the 17-yard line. And it looked like the ball almost came loose again.
Yeah, there's our left-handed snapper, James Stone. He struggled with shotgun snaps all season.
How tough is that for a freshman, Bob?
It's tough. I mean, they've gone back and forth having him snap left-handed, right-handed. You know, you're talking about a true freshman out of high school, no spring practice. They're in the shotgun a high percentage of time. They were fortunate that time that Tyler Bray recovered that football because he fumbled it again. Yeah, look how he holds the football point down like that. Normally you see it flat. They've tried every different mechanic to get that shotgun snap.
And got it back to the quarterback that time. And this is Neal. And Rajon Neal out past the 30 to the 33. But we do want to mention, though, James Stone, the big fellow, the freshman center, was a member of the freshman All-American team. So he was doing something right this year, right?
Oh, he's a great player. He's going to be a great player. And this game has gotten sloppy. But I'll tell you this. These two teams are scratching and clawing right here to try to win this game. So it isn't the prettiest, but the intensity level right now is really high.
Cunningham punting from his own 23.
Wow.
And Searcy is going to field this one with a fair catch at the 22. That was a moonshot by Cunningham, the punter. 45 yards, nothing on the return. North Carolina still up three when we come back to Nashville.
Make your anniversary as memorable as the day you said I do with a romantic weekend celebration at a Gaylord Hotel. We'll help you celebrate this important milestone by giving you your second hotel night free. Relax. Renew. Indulge in style. Gaylord Hotels helps you create memories. To reserve your unforgettable anniversary weekend, visit GaylordHotels.com/anniversary.
So, what do you think?
Basic.
Good choice.
Only Meineke gives me options that work for me, my car, and my budget. My money, my choice, my Meineke.
That's right. It's a beefy crunch burrito. And yes, it's loaded with flaming hot Fritos chips because I don't like playing it safe. I'm a wild man, but also responsible because it's just 99 cents. So why don't you turn around one more time? I dare ya. Oh boy, now what? The new 99-cent Beefy Crunch Burrito. The crunch of Flamin' Hot Fritos chips, seasoned beef, and nacho cheese sauce. All for just 99 cents at Taco Bell.
A Bank. Buy any suit, sport coat, or outerwear and get two free. That's buy one, get any two free. Mix and match all suits, sport coats, blazers, top coats, even leather jackets. Buy one, get any two absolutely free at Joseph A. Bank.
The 2011 All-State Sugar Bowl, Tuesday on ESPN.
So during sign and drive, I can get a CC for just my signature.
That's right. Right now, you can take home a Volkswagen for just your signature.
Like the CC or the Tiguan.
Huh.
Yeah. Plus, every VW includes scheduled carefree maintenance.
Really? That's great.
There you go.
Well, that guy's pretty good, too.
Yeah, it's okay. It's amazing what you can do with a pen. Sign the drive is back. For a limited time, get any 2011 Volkswagen for practically just your signature.
Welcome back to Nashville, and now let's take a look at the Capital One Bowl on January 1st with an intriguing matchup here. Alabama out of the SEC against Michigan State in the Big Ten, and
Saban 0-3 in bowls as Michigan State's head coach when he was there facing his old school. What a year it's been for Coach D'Antonio.
It really has. And, you know, Alabama, you see them ranked 16th right there. In a one-game deal, I would take Alabama, honestly, against anybody. With that talent, that senior quarterback, Mark Ingram, the Julio Jones, the receiver, you know they're going to be well prepared on defense.
You're thinking about that Auburn-Alabama game.
No question. I'd put Alabama right in the mix with Auburn or Oregon in that national championship game. That's how talented I think Alabama is. You know, this game, because you don't have a running game, that's why it's gotten so sloppy.
Interesting.
You know, normally when things start breaking down, you hand the ball off a little bit, let things settle back down. There's nowhere to settle because neither team can throw the football. Tennessee with 20 rushing yards in this game tonight.
Wow. Sean Drone right there, number 20, has gone for over 100, has the long touchdown run from the first half, but been kind of much quiet since first and 15 after the penalty. Gates all day and throws it away. Drone got caught up in traffic, it appeared.
Yeah, and you're allowed to tackle the guy when the ball's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. You're not allowed to hold him and keep him from getting out in the route, but you're allowed to tackle him. So there is no pass interference on a ball thrown behind the line.
It's a second and 15. T.J. Yates is a freshman, broke North Carolina's single-season passing records as a sophomore, broke his ankle and started only six games. As a junior, had 12 touchdowns versus 14 interceptions, and trying to write the final chapter here tonight in a hostile environment. Throws it high and incomplete. Intended for Drone. And it's third and 15. Tennessee players thinking what could have been. They almost had themselves a pick.
What almost looked like Brent Brewer. No question. That's what he's thinking. He went for the big hit, went for the tackle. I'm not sure if he wouldn't have played that football, Mark. That wouldn't have been an interception for a touchdown.
Third and long from the 17. Told you it was a home game pretty much for Tennessee.
We have seen a lot of third and longs in this second half.
Gates to the 27, but not enough for the first down. Complete to Ryan Taylor. And it'll be fourth down, another three and out for Carolina. That drive got off to a poor beginning. Derek Dooley's team still within striking range. Anthony Anderson goes back to collect this punt at about the 39. So the field position tilting a little bit in Tennessee's favor here. Eighth punt of the night.
He's averaged right at about 37 yards a punt. So if Tennessee can field this cleanly, should be good field position.
Takes a little bit of a Carolina bounce. Down to the 37. 10:17 to go in the fourth quarter. Back with more after this.
Home, the place where memories are created. Whether you're buying your first home, raising your family, or settling down to enjoy life, Franklin American Mortgage is a name you can trust. We give our customers the service and dependability they deserve when financing their home. Whether working directly with Franklin American Mortgage or one of our industry partners, we are committed to your dream of home ownership. Franklin American Mortgage. Let our service guide you home.
Come on, Bobby. We can do this, man.
You can be okay.
Ah!
it's a bachelor party.
For drivers who want to get the most out of their cars, it's Bridgestone or nothing.
Geico, saving people money on more than just car insurance.
This new Jetta is awesome.
Yeah. Right now, during Sign Then Drive, you can take home a Volkswagen for just your signature.
Really? Mm-hmm. That's great.
Yeah. Plus, it includes scheduled carefree maintenance.
Huh.
Light screen. There you go. Oh, you need a pen.
I had one here just a second ago.
Who would take my pen?
It's amazing what you can do with a pen. Sign Then Drive is back. For a limited time, get any 2011 Volkswagen for practically just your signature.
ESPN College Football, the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl, is brought to you by Franklin American Mortgage Company. Let our service guide you home. Bridgestone. For drivers who want to get the most out of their cars, it's Bridgestone or nothing. And Discover. It pays to discover. Official card of the Bowl Championship Series.
Under the lights at LP Field, Tennessee with the ball, but down by three. Mark Jones, Bob Davey, Bob. There was a philosophical change when Tyler Bray became quarterback of Tennessee. Have they lost their ability to run the football? Why aren't they?
No, I think it's this. I mean, they have three freshman offensive linemen, true freshmen. One of those guys was an early enrollee for spring football, but you have to take your pick. With no spring football, seriously, and the amount of practice time you have being limited, you can only get good at one thing. And I think they've made the decision. They're going to take all their reps, all their time in practice, Mark, and they're going to work on the passing game. So I think it's more to do with that young offensive line just trying to get good at something and spending most of their time on pass protection. Plus, their wide receivers are their most dynamic players. But it all starts up front. Again, to put it in perspective, when you have three true freshmen starting on the offensive line, there they are right there. You can't get good at everything, so you better pick something, and they've picked the pass.
Second down and eight. Bray passes complete, and they were one shoelace tackle away from a touchdown. Let's go back to Dari.
Mark, watching over on ESPN2, Stanford leads Connecticut 30-19. Connecticut going for a 91st straight win. Stanford, the last team that beat them. Stanford had a 13-point lead. That is the largest deficit Connecticut has faced in their last 91 games. Bo Pelini in Nebraska getting set for the Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl against Washington. We're about a half hour from kick in San Diego.
All right, Jake Locker going to be closing out his career in that game. Bray, meanwhile, completing his career-high 21st pass. Make that 22 as Denarius Moore. And another Tennessee first down at the 32 off the 16-yard pickup.
Yeah, Denarius Moore heating up. I said earlier, the last four games of the season, of all the receivers in the country, Denarius Moore is playing as good as anybody. Not a big guy, but look at the effort. Another senior that's been through three coaches trying to finish this thing out with a big win. I mean, I love what these kids are bringing to the table right here.
First and 10. Bray off the play action. Finds Neal. And Neal is tackled at about the 27.
We talk about Tyler Bray playing on instincts right now. He's not well oiled. Watch the delivery off balance right here on this throw. I mean, that's just raw talent. I'm going to kid Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator. Just don't overcoach him, right? You're going to coach him hard. All of a sudden, you'll screw him up, man. Let him let it rip.
Second and three, they hand it off. And that's Rajah Neal. Close to the first down. Looks like he got it. Interesting, Bob, that they've changed things up and gone with Neal more so than Poole.
Yeah. Here.
As Poole comes back into the game.
How valuable Tennessee having won four games in November to get to a bowl game. Mark, how else could you simulate this kind of experience for all these freshmen, plus the momentum it could give you if you come out of here with a win?
Great turnaround in the, starting in the month of November. 7.5 minutes to go. Bray, that time sacked back at the 31 by Zach Brown and Quinton Coples. Two key cogs defensively tonight for Carolina come up with a huge play.
Yeah, Zach Brown, the speed linebacker, rushing upfield, getting his start tonight because Bruce Carter's not starting because of injury. And Quinton Coples, hey, if you're Butch Davis, Quinton Coples a junior, you better talk to him about staying because I'm telling you something, if I'm an NFL scout or coach watching this game, this kid's a player.
Fourth sack tonight for North Carolina. Ajon Neal back in the backfield. Second and 19. Neal with the carry and nowhere to go. That defense seeking him out and bringing him down at the 30. It was Dante Page Moss who was bandaged up and got back into the game. Well, New Year's Eve will actually begin the official start of the year of the quarterback. It'll be rung in with a live show from San Diego. The show will include a look back at the quarterback position in 2010, look ahead to 2011. There'll be a sneak peek at the Tim Tebow documentary, as well as interviews with current NFL quarterbacks and a sports science feature, which will give a new perspective on the position. New Year's Eve beginning at 11 Eastern.
Well, if you're Tyler Bray, don't take a sack, don't turn it over, because your kicker, Daniel Lincoln, he's 5 for 5 from 40 to 49.
Bray to pick Moore. First and goal, Tennessee.
It was third and long. Watch how soft Carolina plays. Look at the corner retreating in a soft cover two. They just hit the little slant to Nadarius Moore. He breaks the tackle of the free safety. That was too easy on third and long. Just too soft, allowing him to get the ball in the hands of that playmaker.
That's his senior coming to the fore. First and goal, backs lining up out of the eye. Bray into the end zone. And overshoots his intended receiver again, this time Moore again.
Yeah, he was open. Denarius Moore open in the corner of the end zone. And don't even think about the running game. It's first and goal on the 9. Little double pump fake again. Tyler Bray just missed that one right there.
And knew he had it. Freshman who became the starter with 4 games to go in the regular season. Was 4-0, looking for his 5th win in a row tonight. Second and goal. Play fake. Justin Hunter, who made All-SEC All-Freshman, with the go-ahead catch. And the extra point is missed, which means it's just a field goal game.
Cam Newton, the biggest story in college football this year, right?
Yes.
Maybe the second biggest down the stretch. Field goal kickers missing extra points and short field goal.
We saw it in the Georgia Tech game just a few weeks ago.
Boise State, how about Arizona having 2 extra points blocked? That's the second biggest story of the year, and that's good news for Carolina right now.
The Tostitos BCS National Championship game, January 10th on ESPN.
I really should be in the market, but...
The volatility?
Exactly. I'm this close to retirement. That's the money I need to live on.
You know, Prudential has this video you should see. My advisor recommended it.
Where do I see it?
RetirementRedZone.com. I learned some things there that really helped.
Like?
Like how to invest now when it's your retirement income at stake.
Huh, I'll check it out.
Need a smarter approach to investing for retirement? Watch our video at retirementredzone.com. Then talk to your financial professional.
Right on the money.
At Amway, our positive outlook comes naturally. We harvest healthy plant ingredients from our own organic farms, ingredients found in our Nutrilite supplements, and offer more than 450 quality products, from planet-positive cleaners to botanically-infused skincare. Positivity. Powering the products, the people, and the businesses of Amway. To learn more, contact an Amway independent business owner.
It was the biggest race of the year. And no matter what, I was going to win. Sometimes things happen you just can't explain.
Oh, I believe there are angels among us.
And some things are more important than winning.
Send down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me.
I don't remember who won the race that day.
Show us how to live.
And I'll never forget how I felt.
Teach us how to give, to guide us.
Including others. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
One more look at that touchdown pass from Tyler Bray to another freshman, Justin Hunter.
Yeah, good job of Tyler Bray right there. Really going to his second read. It was obvious he wanted to throw the ball out to the front side. The talented freshman. Extra point, I'm not sure Daniel Lincoln just flat kicked that low, but it did look like Tydrick Powell, number 91, got up there and hit it with his right hand. But it looked like the trajectory of that ball was low from the very beginning.
Back to Bray. That was his third touchdown pass today. And a real coming out putter again for Bray. But the margin now just 3 points. Searcy on the kick return. Out to the 26. Let's go down to Kara.
Well, we keep hearing about how calm and collected Tyler Bray is, but before that last offensive drive, an emotional, passionate showing on the sideline, rallying the troops. They score, and just now, guys, I witnessed him walk up to the entire offensive line and say, it's time. We've got to play smart. We've got to finish this. Coach Dooley came back to the offense and said, if we get the ball back, we're going to score. We need to win this game. It was really exciting to witness firsthand.
And he's really going up. And clutch on that last drive.
You remember the end of the first half, Tennessee scored. T.J. Yates took Carolina right down the field.
There's Drone on the run. Out to the 30-yard line. Picks up 4 on the play. 5 minutes to go. Carolina with a full complement of 3 timeouts. Tennessee also with 3 timeouts.
Yeah, T.J. Yates, 44 starts. Has 31 school records. Let's see if he can respond to the young freshman's drive from Tennessee. Now the difference, he's doing it on the road.
Tennessee looking for a 16th straight win here in Nashville. Yates complete with the flat. A nice move by Drone. On the move, Sean Drone. But there's a flag down to play all the way back at the 28.
Yeah, we're going to get a legal shift right here.
Wow, that would kill.
That kills you.
Illegal shift. We had 2 players moving on the offense. 5-yard penalty. We'll repeat. Second down.
Take one more look at what happened here.
Yeah, I don't think the fullback ever got set. Looked to me like the fullback, Curtis Boyd, that time was moving as that ball was snapped.
Well, Drum made a great catch and run after the catch.
Under 4 minutes to go. Gates complete at the 33 to Ryan Taylor. They're going to start thinking about perhaps getting in field goal range for Casey Barth. 8 yard pickup on the play. Or just getting the first down, period. 3.5 to go. 3 timeouts remaining as well for Carolina.
It's a free play right now.
And he flags down and they finally blow it dead. Bob, with this noise, this is where home field advantage really officially or unofficially comes in play for Tennessee.
Well, this is a huge, huge call right here because it's either going to be first down for Carolina or third and about 9, depending on which way this call goes.
The defense was in the neutral zone.
What a veteran quarterback with 44 starts just changing that snap count up a little bit right there. Caught Tennessee, 2 defensive linemen in the neutral zone when that ball was snapped.
Well, you see North Carolina's proficiency away from Chapel Hill this year, 4-1 on the road, and you can call this a neutral site game, but it's really a home game for Tennessee. So it's currently a road game for Carolina.
Time not at all the issue with 3 timeouts for Carolina. It's all about just execution right here.
Yates with plenty of time. Got away from 1. Catch and a first down at the 48-yard line by Dwight Jones, who's been conspicuous by his silence tonight.
Yeah, and we got a late flag over there on that Tennessee sideline.
Jones came up out of the pile without his hat.
Again, TJ Yates keeping that play alive, scrambling to his left. Found Dwight Jones. Let's see what this call is.
Number 83 of North Carolina stepped out of bounds and then will first to touch the ball. There is no yardage. Clearly, it's loss of down. Second down.
So it's incomplete. They're saying he went out of bounds to make the catch.
Well, he went out of bounds and then came back in and was the first one to touch the football. You see right there, Tennessee's coaches saw that. He was out of bounds, came back in, and right there, you see the staff. If we run that back, see the assistant coach right here? He's helping that Big Ten official.
And also a loss of down on the play. No doubt about this one, complete. Back to Jones, and Jones takes it all the way for the first down and then some. Stops the clock with 2:29 to go.
Dwight Jones, 223 yards against Florida State, 200 yards against Virginia, has had some giant games. And you said it, has been quiet up till now. But not much different. You know, Denarius Moore had been quiet all night for Tennessee. So your big-time guys stepping up here at the end of this game.
Carolina on Tennessee's side of midfield after the 16-yard gain. Yates throws it. Incomplete. And a flag. They're going to get him for grounding.
Yeah, I don't think the ball crossed the line of scrimmage, which is going to be intentional grounding.
Malik Jackson and Gerald Williams there for the pressure.
Intentional grounding. On the first team of the offense, the ball did not make it beyond the line of scrimmage. It's a spot foul, loss of down, second down.
That's 2 loss of downs on this drive. But again, yeah, that football was not thrown beyond the original line of scrimmage, and man, that is a big, big penalty.
Moves it all the way back to the 37.
Did a heck of a job getting rid of the football. But clearly not even close to the line of scrimmage.
Jackson and Williams never gave up on the play. Quick slant, complete. Out to the 44-yard line. That's Jones again with a catch. Friday, Capital One Bowl. We continues. Three games on ESPN at noon. South Florida takes on Clemson in the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Then at 3:30, Georgia takes on Central Florida in the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. And at 7:30, South Carolina takes on Florida State in the Chick-fil-A Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN on Friday. So it's third down and long coming up for North Carolina. They trail by 3 points. What do you do here if you're Butch Davis? What do you call it?
Well, first of all, you're going for it on fourth down. So you have two downs to make 20 yards. And the big receiver, number 83, is hot right now. I would get the football in his hands. If I'm Tennessee, no penalties. Do not give them the first down with a pass interference or a late hit on the quarterback. So it's third down and 20. You have two downs to make it if you're Carolina. If you're Tennessee, make them execute. Don't have a silly penalty.
When you talk about field goal range for Casey Barth, the place kicker for North Carolina, he has a long of 45 yards, and he's kicked it pretty well this year. He hasn't missed that many. He has a very high percentage. Yeah. At what point do you start thinking field goal? How long do you let it go?
Yeah, Casey Barth's a great kicker. I mean, his brother kicked at Carolina. He's at the Bucks right now. His brother isn't going to help him right now. But I'll say this, that wind's coming out of the south a little bit. He'll have to kick this into the wind.
J. Yates on third down, 4 of 11 tonight. Looking at a third and 20 here.
You have to think Dwight Jones at 6'4", number 83, Carolina's best receiver.
1:47 to play. As you mentioned, it's four down territory.
If you're Tennessee, keep T.J. Yates in that pocket. Do not let him scramble. He has broken contains several times tonight, which have resulted in big plays. If you're a defensive end, keep him between the tackles.
Incomplete. Reves. Yates of Carolina. Down to its final opportunity, 4th and 20. Two timeouts to go.
Is there any kind of a Boise State looking lateral? What is your 4th and 20 call if you're Butch Davis?
It was in and out of the hands of Jones.
He just dropped the football.
Yates apparently put it right there.
It hit him right between the numbers. Dwight Jones on the square end had first down yardage and dropped the football.
Wow. Hit him between the 8 and the 3. If you're Yates, you couldn't ask for a better chance.
It looked like he didn't expect that football. He was a little late reacting.
At Franklin American Mortgage, we've always been committed to helping people achieve the dream of home ownership. We specialize in conventional mortgages and have emerged as one of the industry's largest FHA and VA lenders. Whether you're working directly with Franklin American Mortgage or one of our valued industry partners, our goal remains the same: relationships built on service. Find out why more customers are choosing Franklin American Mortgage for all of their lending needs.
So during sign and drive, I can get a CC for just my signature.
That's right. Right now, you can take home a Volkswagen for just your signature.
Like the CC or the Tiguan.
Oh.
Yeah. Plus, every VW includes scheduled carefree maintenance.
Really? That's great.
There you go.
Well, that guy's pretty good, too.
Yeah. It's okay. It's amazing what you can do with a pen. Sign the Drive is back. For a limited time, get any 2011 Volkswagen for practically just your signature.
We talk about traditions. We talk about
the big turkey and the big pernil.
I call Europe a lot, Italy, Spain.
I'm in touch with old friends.
My mom and I are very chatty.
That's one of the cool things with Vonage. It's one set price, unlimited calling, and no surprises at the end of the month.
No annual contract? I mean, that's even better.
Once you try it, you're going to stick with it.
I'm Judy Compress, and this was my last bill before I switched to Vonage.
This holiday, switch your home phone to Vonage and get unlimited domestic and international calling now with no annual contract.
Dari Noka in studio over on ESPN2 right now. Connecticut trails Stanford at the half, 34-30. Maya Moore, 2-for-6, 6 points for the National Player of the Year. Third time during this streak of what is now 90 straight wins that Connecticut has trailed at the half, and every time it's been against Stanford. Don't forget, coming up next, Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl. Jake Locker's collegiate finale, Washington, Nebraska. That's next, guys.
All right, Dari, let's take one more look at that drop by Dwight Jones. What do you make of what transpired on that play, Coach?
To me, Dwight Jones is lackadaisical. You didn't see him snap that head around like he really wasn't expecting the ball to be thrown. That was 4th and 20. That was a first down right there for Carolina. And he is their best receiver, but he didn't expect the football.
As O'Neal dotted the eye, he gets the carry, the freshman. To try and strip this loose, but he knows that too. An opportunity lost on the drop by Jones. And Tyler Bray, by contrast, has been cash money today for Tennessee.
Well, career high attempts, 42. Career high completions, 25. 3 touchdowns, he had the 2 interceptions.
And the not-so-laid-back California kid, yeah. That's their insignia. That's their thing. They call it loco.
Yeah.
And they're about to go crazy with a win if they can hang on.
I've got to ask you something, though. Honestly, not to stir anything up, but what did the kid from Kansas State do on the touchdown any different than Tyler Bray did right there?
Yeah. You just like a little bit of consistency when it comes to that unsportsmanlike conduct call. 2nd and 9. That's Neal again, brought down immediately by Zach Brown. And Carolina with 1 timeout remaining. And they use it. So Tennessee is going to have to get a first down here. With 1:26 to go.
Well, I mentioned earlier about for Derek Dooley. Tangible evidence that your plan works. If you can come out of here having won 5 straight games, you have a winning season. That's pretty good evidence.
And while people were questioning those 4 wins in a row against maybe not the highest level of competition, this would be their first win against an FBS team with a winning record. Yeah. So there's some credibility and a potential victory here in the next 1:26 if Tennessee can hang on.
And you know what? None of that matters. It's 5 straight wins. It's a winning record. And you have momentum on your side with some young talent that everybody in the country sees.
3rd and 12. Tight ends and an I formation. Neal runs it to the 45. Gains about 2 on the play. And North Carolina unable to stop the clock now. Here's what's coming up next. The Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl featuring Nebraska against Jake Locker's Washington Huskies.
Well, it's 4th down here. Chad Cunningham has had 3 punts blocked in his career. Slow get off time tonight. We've had him at about 2.4 seconds. Obviously, he'll have 1 thing right now as a goal, just get that football off.
They saw that Giants Eagles game, right? I don't want to bring it up.
Exactly.
And now Tennessee calls one of its remaining timeouts. And a good time now for our Capital One player of the game. This guy that's really emerged and kind of evolved before our own eyes tonight, Tyler Bray. 25 of 42, a career high 25 completions and 42 attempts.
You know, Lane Kiffin, there's been a lot of signs in this stadium tonight, a lot of animosity. He left one gift for Tennessee. He recruited Tyler Bray now. Because I think he has a chance to be a star.
He wasn't all that laid back tonight. Became a little bit more vocal on the sidelines. It's one of the signs we saw earlier tonight. Here's the punt from Cunningham. We'll go into the end zone and come right back out. Is that what you want, Bob? I mean,
yeah.
would you
just get that football
okay.
off. That's what happened with the Eagles and the Giants.
Okay.
You try to get a little too cute. You try to get a little too greedy and talk about field position. In this situation, just get that football off because Carolina has no timeouts.
They got 31 seconds to go. And they're 80 yards away. The career-long field goal for Casey Barth is 49 yards. First and 10. Yates downfield. Open his right.
We got a penalty.
And a flag. That's going to be a launch on the reception.
Yeah.
Big catch by Harrelson.
Great catch. And then Jansen Jackson came in, and the officials ruled he led with his helmet. He launched himself at him. No question.
Wow.
Wow.
Unnecessary roughness.
That's going to tag a bunch more yardage on. There's the launch.
And mark the first point. Is how Todd Harrelson came that open right there.
From the end of the catch, first down.
There's no argument by Derek Dooley.
25 seconds to go, and in a blink, North Carolina close to the edges of field goal range here.
And Carolina with no timeouts. Tennessee's offsides there.
Pass complete. The 31, there's a flag down on the far side of the field. Things unraveling a little bit here for Tennessee. With 14 seconds to go, Jones, who dropped it earlier, made the catch this time.
Yes.
There is no play. We were buzzed. The previous play is under further review.
Oh, wow. They're going to go back to the catch. Back to the catch that was made on the previous play by Harrelson.
Yeah, they're going to go back and see if he had control of that football when he came down on the ground.
And Butch Davis.
But you know what? If you're Butch Davis right now, he's doing a great job coaching. You can't control this replay. Let's see if he had possession right here. The ball juggled, but did he retain possession? You couldn't see.
Not from that angle, and it was ruled a catch on the field.
Yeah. There's no question that Jansen Jackson jarred that football. But the question is, did Todd Harrelson regain possession before he hit the ground? Right there, that ball's loose. You can't turn that call over.
Here's a different angle. That's kind of, looks like he held on.
Well,
still inconclusive.
Yeah.
That's all these angles. Here's a different shot. I would say that he caught it.
Again, and I know fans at home know this, it was ruled a catch. So it has to be indisputable or overwhelming evidence that that ball was loose. And I don't think there is indisputable evidence.
So with the catch and the subsequent penalty that was tacked on, it immediately moved them to the fringes of field goal range. There's a look at Casey Barth. the place kicker, whose career long is 49. But they're still reviewing that last catch by Todd Harrelson. Officials said that they were buzzed prior to that last play, and that's why they blew it dead, that there was no play. And they reset the clock back to 25 seconds.
Isn't it appropriate? These two teams. Think of all these two teams have been through since August 1st. And it's coming down right here to this.
Catch or no catch.
I don't think you can overturn that. Now, I see that it's very close. That football was wobbling a little bit. But since it was ruled a catch by Todd Harrelson, I think you have to let that stand as a catch.
And by the way, that actually was a pretty decent throw by T.J. Yates, who was despondent after a great...
You know, there's one other issue, though. Was that elbow out of bounds when he came down, regardless of the security of the football? I still think it stands.
Well, they're going to put some time back on the clock. It's at 25 right now. A lot riding on this decision. During this extra time, you figure Butch Davis has got a couple plays called, right? A couple scenarios? Yeah.
And he's hoping he's calling,
right?
He's hoping he's calling that play from right there at the 36-yard line. This place is pretty quiet for 70,000 people, huh?
Replay buzzed us to stop the play to review as far as whether the catch was made. That play has been confirmed. It was a catch and a 15-yard penalty. There is no play. We'll reset the game clock to 2:06.
That's a great job by that Big Ten crew. Seriously, that play was so critical. They took their time. He explained that. And now 25 seconds and no timeouts.
We've got time for a couple plays here. From here, it would be a 52-yard field goal. They reset the clock to 26 now. First and 10.
I wonder if Dwight Jones gets another opportunity, Mark.
Quick slant. There it is. Dwight Jones. And that might be a late hit. No flag.
Now you have to get up there and just spike that football if you're Carolina.
And Yates stops the clock after the 12-yard gain.
That's LaMarcus Thomas coming in late, number 42. Let's take a look at this again at the end of this play. That's a penalty.
That looked like a penalty for sure. I mean, Greg Jones was down. He wanted the flag as well, obviously. But the nose of the ball resting at the 25.
Let's take a look again. Oh, there's no question. That's every bit as bad, if not worse, than Jansen Jackson's penalty.
Here we go, second and 10. 16 seconds to go. Carolina without timeouts.
Now they're going to get up there and spike that football.
And drawn down to the 17. They got to get up there and spike it. 5 seconds to go.
What are they doing? Spike it!
They're going to lose it.
I think there's a second left.
Is there a flag?
Yeah, there's a flag. But I think there was a second left when he spiked that football. Carolina had about 13 or 14 people on the field.
We've got to sort this out. Here's the call.
The game is over.
Oh, it's done.
Of all the clock management, mismanagement situations we've seen all season, that may have been the worst. Carolina with the opportunity to get up there and spike the football. Looked like they tried to get the field goal team on the field. But Mark, I thought there was a second left when that football ultimately was spiked. They're going to review this.
Wow.
I thought there was a second left when he spiked that ball.
And Casey Barr is still warming up.
And I'll tell you something, Butch Davis in Carolina, if there's a second left, will have survived terrible clock management.
This almost makes you think of Tennessee's game against LSU, in which Tennessee was on the wrong end of things.
Very close. But what happened? They ran the football to Sean Drone. The clock was winding down. They had time to clock it and spike the ball, but there was chaos because they tried to run the field goal team out. But I do think he was able to spike that ball with the second left. That was just looking at it live. Now we're going to look at it real time.
Jones gets another opportunity, Mark.
Quick slant.
There it is. Now there's a missed late hit right there.
That might be a late hit. No flag. And this is where they tried to.
Now he spikes the football. 16 seconds left. Now here comes the play to Sean Drone.
This is real time we're watching it in.
Okay. The officials are looking at exactly what we're looking at. And we'll make this decision.
Now this is going to be the run to Drone.
And right now the decision is, if you're Carolina, get up there and spike the ball. But you see the field goal team trying to get on the field. But did he spike it with 1 second left? Just watch the snap. He spiked it with 1 second left. They're going to get a penalty, Mark, but there's going to be a second left, and they will have a field goal opportunity here.
So they're going to move it back.
They're going to move it back, but there's a second left, and they'll get a chance.
Casey Barth.
For Casey Barth.
Will have an opportunity.
The offensive team had more than 11 players on the field. Ball was snapped and it hit the ground with 1 second.
That is a great job by that Big Ten crew. And anybody that questions instant replay and its significance in college football.
So here we go. Casey Barth from 37 yards away. Casey Barth lining up.
Will Tennessee ice him?
They've got two timeouts remaining.
I think they should let him kick it because there's some chaos right now. Don't you?
Yeah.
Don't ice him and let it calm down.
From 38 yards out. Barth.
He made it.
Sends us into overtime after all the chaos. Wow.
Butch Davis and Carolina survive a clock management meltdown. But how about the Tennessee defense? Tennessee taking that ball because of a huge Carolina taking that ball because of a huge completion.
There was the catch by Harrelson, then the penalty.
Okay, here's the run at the end of the football game right here. This is where Carolina gets caught between spiking the football or getting their field goal team out. They get it spiked with 1 second. Casey Barth ties the game. Tennessee now has just been assessed a unsportsmanlike penalty. And it's of no significance because we're going to overtime.
An incredible, implausible finish. As Derek Dooley argues with the officials, but to no avail.
What a season for North Carolina and Tennessee. You couldn't make this stuff up.
Ask Casey Barth. He'll tell you.
Mm-hmm. It was 1975. My professor at Berkeley asked me if I wanted to change the world. I said, sure. Well, let's grow some algae. And that's what started it. ExxonMobil and Synthetic Genomics have built a new facility to identify the most productive strains of algae. Algae are amazing little critters. They secrete oil, which we could turn into biofuels. They also absorb CO2. We're hoping to supplement the fuels that we use in our vehicles and to do this at a large enough scale to someday help meet the world's energy demands.
Dari Noka in studio, back to Nashville in seconds. Lots to tell you. Over on ESPN2 right now, Connecticut's 90-game winning streak in jeopardy against the last team that beat them. That is Stanford. It is in Palo Alto. Stanford up by 6 right now. If you are waiting to watch the Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl, Nebraska and Washington, a couple of things. Yes, Washington leads 7-0. They lost by 35 to Nebraska in Seattle this season. The other thing is it's on ESPNU at the moment. As soon as North Carolina, Tennessee is over, Huskies go to ESPN. In the meantime, enjoy overtime.
Welcome back, everyone, to Music City, USA, Nashville, where if you were with us a moment ago, you witnessed an incredible ending to this game between North Carolina and Tennessee. This was the pass that set it up. With 31 seconds to go, Yates completes it to Harrelson and the subsequent launching penalty on Jansen Jackson. That added on some more time once they decided that the catch was actually good. And then this run by Sean Drone with time winding down. Then the ensuing confusion as the field goal unit prematurely tried to get onto the field, and Yates alertly spiked the ball. And watch the clock. 1 second to go. And after reviewing how much time was remaining, Casey Barth from 39 yards out sends us into the overtime.
And Mark, here's the thing. There was an unsportsmanlike flag thrown on Tennessee. That will carry over, I believe, into overtime. So they won't start on the 25, depending if Tennessee's on offense or defense. They're going to carry that personal foul into this overtime if, in fact, that flag was thrown.
So that affects their, obviously, their
drive
here.
Let's listen and see.
...has the option as far as calling heads or tails. Tails is called.
Find out.
It's a head. Tennessee has won the toss. They have elected to go on defense. You will go on offense. Which end of the field do you want to play? All right, North Carolina, Tennessee down here, please. North Carolina will go on offense at the 12.5
yeah.
yard line.
Carolina gets that ball at the 12.5 yard line.
That's a big advantage.
Huge advantage. If we can go back and see what that unsportsmanlike conduct penalty was on Tennessee, the last play of the game that carries over into overtime.
Well, you think about the ending of this one in regulation with the unsportsmanlike, and then the Kansas State game, the unsportsmanlike penalty.
Let's look at the field goal that's made and see if we can see where this flag came from. It may have come from the bench. I hate to speculate. There it was right there. They roughed the kicker. He roughed the kicker.
And working now with just half the field from the 12.5. First down in overtime. Yates completes it down to the 5. That was Ryan Taylor. To think that they were down and out with 31 seconds to go deep in their own territory in regulation. No timeouts remaining.
All those things, and then to cap it off, you rough the kicker on the game-winning tying, the game-tying field goal with no time left, and that penalty carries over into overtime and puts them at the 12.5 yard line, half the distance to the goal.
Second and 3. Drone trying to get to the edge. It's a foot race. Brought down.
Got another
face mask. Sean Drone was brought down by the face mask.
And that's going to be a penalty and a first down.
Yeah, Prentice Wagner.
Boy, Tennessee is imploding right now.
How fast can it unravel? With 30 seconds, that's clearly a face mask, but with 30 seconds left in this game, we're talking about Tennessee winning five straight games. Tangible evidence that the plan is in place. All of a sudden, it unravels on Tennessee.
First and goal now.
And the big offensive fullback in there at about 300 pounds.
Tied up to Drone. And he gets in for the score. Oh, no, they're going to mark it at the one. Looked like he ended up all the way in the end zone. But his knee may have touched.
This will be reviewed as well. Big Tydrick Powell, the defensive tackle at fullback. Sean Drone, boy, that is very close. I think that call will stand, though.
Here they go on second down. Wow. Gibbs keeps it himself. No signal yet. Touchdown now. They're going to go for one on the extra point. Here's one more look. Yates. He didn't make it by much on that first effort.
Well, it's the little bit of the bush push by Tydrick Powell. The defensive tackle in there at fullback pushed him into the end zone.
Can't take these extra points for granted. We've seen it. And Carolina up by 7 points.
Mark, you just said that. This all really started with Tennessee Daniel Lincoln missing that extra point. Then Tennessee with three personal fouls in the last 30 seconds of this game.
And Bob, you think about it, Tennessee really did get away with a late hit too on that last drive.
Could have been four personal fouls.
Now they'll start off, the Volunteers will, first and 10 from the 25 in overtime. They must score a touchdown to equalize or else it's over.
Quentin Copel's number 90. Get him blocked if you're Tennessee.
Ray hands it off. That's number 28, Torin Poole. Down after a gain of about four on the play. Second down and six. Boy, this one seemed to be on ice for the Tennessee Volunteers in their fifth win. And Tyler Bray already named our player of the game with a career high in passing completions and attempts.
The positive, obviously Tennessee knows they need a touchdown. So it's four downs.
Ray into the end zone. Touchdown! Wow! Unbelievable! Luke Stalker.
You play too deep coverage. You ask that linebacker to run down the middle of that field. Watch Kevin Riddick, 48. This is great coverage down the middle of the field on Stalker. He just goes up and makes the play. Another senior stepping up, fighting to the very end.
Here's the extra point.
He missed it earlier.
You kind of hold your breath.
Tyler Bray is no ordinary freshman.
Not anymore. What a night. A couple of teams authoring a new chapter in a Music City miracle. Tyler Bray.
You want enough?
And feeling brash.
You want another personal foul penalty? Keep doing that.
That's going to go right in your glove. See that? Great job. Okay, now let's get ready for the ball. Here it comes. There you go.
Good catch. Perfect.
All right, now for the best part. Let's see your port. Ooh, let's get those in the bowl. These are way too good to waste, right?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go for it. Around the bowl. And
share what you love with who you love. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
They're great.
Oh, good catch, Dad.
Anoka in Bristol, back to Nashville in a moment. 50-44, Stanford continues to lead Connecticut, 10.5 to go. Huskies, 90-game winning streak on the line right now at Stanford. Meanwhile, Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl, Chris Polk, touchdown, Huskies. This after a Rex Burkhead fumble, they lead Nebraska 7-0. It's on ESPNU. We'll be on ESPN after we're done in Nashville.
Hey, Dari, you know, Tyler Brabov isn't the shy guy anymore, is he?
Well, I'll say this. Derek Dooley needs to get this corrected because this has happened repeatedly tonight. That can easily be a personal foul penalty. I can see if a guy does it one time, but as a coaching staff, you need to see that and you need to get that corrected. I mean, that kid at Kansas State got called for that today. Right. He's done it every touchdown.
It's going to be North Carolina football now.
First and 10, 25-yard line.
And you have to say right now, Tennessee survived that shocking momentum switch at the end of that game. You know, to come through that with Carolina starting at the 12.5-yard line, particularly the way that game ended, just to get it to the second overtime is a big win for Tennessee.
27-27, Tennessee with the ball. On the 25. Jones in motion. And they give it to the tailback, Torn Poole.
And you wonder, as good as Tyler Bray is, he's still a freshman. And he finished this thing out mistake-free. You know, he did two interceptions early. Can he finish it? He seems like an unflappable guy, though. He really does, doesn't he?
Career highs and completions and passing attempts tonight. Don't forget, coming up next, the Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl.
You have to think about Luke Stocker, the tight end. Number 88 flexed out here as a wide receiver.
And second down. Gray underneath completes it to Jones. And Jones is stopped up. But it looks like he got close enough and may have gotten the first down. They're going to give him a favorable spot on his forward progress. It's going to be first down, Tennessee. 1-9 for the freshman quarterback, Tyler Bray. 6'6", 210, a freshman, and became the starter in the last four games of the regular season. And what a way to end this year.
I'd love to get Peyton Manning on the phone right now because you know he's watching. And just ask him, what do you think of this young freshman? I mean, you can see that he has some skills that you can't teach. Great instincts.
On first down. Handed off to Poole, who slips and falls. And falls forward to about the 13-yard line.
I think
gained a yard on the play.
I think Tennessee might have got away with a hold. Watch Tydrick 91 right here. Man, he got tackled from behind right there. They're fortunate. They got away with one right there.
Second and 9. Capacity crowd, bowl record crowd watching. 80% of them from Tennessee. Play action. Picked off. Sturdivant. And North Carolina now can win it on a field goal. Quentin Sturdivant with the pick. He's still a freshman. You were saying a moment ago, yeah. Bob.
Could he finish mistake-free because he is still a freshman? Quan Sturdivant, the senior linebacker, just threw it to him. You saw number 46 slipped. Channing Fugate, the fullback. But a freshman is still a freshman. But Derek Dooley, you've got a special one
that you can develop. Another big twist in this night of twists and turns. They're going to whistle this one dead before the snap.
Timeout.
Tennessee calling a timeout. 1 timeout left. Well, Casey Barth has already kicked a big field goal tonight, the one that sent it into overtime. He's connected from 28 and then 39.
And these are always difficult coaching decisions right here. Do you play it safe and do you play it cautious for the field goal? Sometimes that backfires on you. Or do you let it rip a little bit and play like you have to score? That's always the dilemma. You know, when you have a senior quarterback like T.J. Yates with 44 starts, I don't think you necessarily have to play just for the field goal right here.
Well, with the way that Yates seemed to be playing, Bob, in this last quarter, the last dying minutes of regulation at least, when he brought his team from deep in their own zone with 31 seconds to go and tied it up, you'd think the inclination is to let him play a little bit. He's hit 7 of his last 9 passes. Drawn with a great move. John Drawn with a first down. And Drawn gets it deep into Tennessee territory. Ray watching helplessly now.
Got a great block by number 33, Wilson, the fullback. Watch right there. And then good movement out in space on Jansen Jackson.
Drone with a big run down to the 9.
That shows you the life of a quarterback in big-time college football. The highest of highs and now the lowest of lows.
Drone down to the 6-yard line.
He's going
to
kick the field goal right here.
I think you set it up. Here it comes. Here comes the field goal unit. North Carolina trying to take advantage of that turnover. The interception thrown by Tyler Bray. And in comes Casey Barth. He's made a couple already tonight.
I always think about that snapper, Mark House, the holder, Trace Jones. It's not just Barth. It's the whole mechanics.
From 23 yards out. And Carolina takes it home. Butch Davis's North Carolina Tar Heels notched their 8th win of the year in a tumultuous, turbulent season. And the freshman quarterback, Tyler Bray, feeling agony and despair on the other end of the spectrum.
Does anybody think now there's too many bowl games? This was a 7-5 team against a 6-6 team. No teams could have fought any harder than these two teams fought.
Our final score, North Carolina defeating Tennessee 30-27 in a thrilling game here in Nashville. Right now, we send you to Dari Noka. Dari?